26th Rose Bowl starts the bowl championship series. Big Ten champion Wisconsin Badgers' second straight trip to Pasadena, led by their big running back who's won every prize possible and set a new rushing record for college football, Ron Dayne.
35-30. Dayne down the 25. Touchdown, Wisconsin.
Pac-10 champion Stanford rebounded from a crushing loss at the start of the season. But they've been dealt a blow by fate. All-American wide receiver Troy Walters dislocating his right wrist. An injury that jarred the team to the core.
I'm sick to my stomach.
There's always that emotional scar when one of your best players falls down.
I want to win this game for Troy.
The supersonic one, limited if not parked. But there are others in this Stanford Air group ready to fly in the Rose Bowl, presented by AT&T. This is the 86th playing of the Rose Bowl game, the 54th time the Big Ten Pac-10 champions have met. And this first game in the new century matches the Stanford Cardinal and the Wisconsin Badgers. And a happy new year from all of us out here at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena, California. The Rose Bowl presented by AT&T. Keith Jackson along with Dan Fouts and Todd Harris. We've had a miracle recovery by the injured Stanford Cardinal. Troy Walters is going to start.
It must be the new millennium, Keith, because Stanford needs Troy Walters. They need Willie Howard. They're both going to play. They're not going to be 100%, but they're the leaders of this football team. They're needed.
Offensive weapons very much in favor of Stanford's only chance at surviving this afternoon's football game. The Badgers are big and burly and tough. Stanford, Wisconsin, coming up.
The 2004 Taurus pregame show, brought to you by the new 2004 Taurus with the advanced personal safety system.
What if your car knew you, anticipated your needs, and then reacted to meet them? What if it could adjust to how long your legs are? What if it could help protect you in an accident? With sensors that know where your seat is positioned and the severity of the crash, so the front airbags react to you. What if it went even further? Wouldn't that make sense? What if it could prevent potential problems? Or light the road better at night? What if its testing exceeded anything the real world can dish out? Is that possible? What if it made genius obvious and brilliance accessible? It's time to stop wondering what if. Introducing the new 2004 Taurus.
Spanish commentary for this game can be heard using the SAP feature on your TV set where available. Brought to you by National Car Rental.
The other near miracle recovery has come with this man, Barry Alvarez, who's had a tremendous record during the course of the 90s. A double operation infection on his knee. He's been on a cane and crutches and a chair and all of that. This is the first time since the operation that we've seen him on the sideline to handle his football team, so he felt good this morning and said, I'm going to the field. Vitaly Pozetsky kicks off for Wisconsin. Stanford won the toss. They want the ball. The kick is in the air and short at the 10 to Ryan Wells, who comes up the middle to about the 25. Now let's join our colleague on the field, Todd Harris.
Thank you, Keith. Well, yesterday the rumors began, and this morning hope turned into reality. Stanford's All-American Troy Walters will not only play, he's going to start. What they're going to do? Two layers of orthoplast, a layer of foam, and a heavy tape job. Initially, a hand surgeon looked at it, said, no way, that wasn't good enough for Troy Walters. They talked to some NFL team doctors. They said, brace it, and the kid can play. And we know Troy Walters. And I got to tell you, in warm-ups, he didn't drop a ball. Keith?
All right, here we go to the air, right out of the box. It is Jermaine Fitz getting up to the 30-yard line for a pickup of about 5 yards. Jamar Fletcher brought him down. The AT&T starting lineups for the Stanford Cardinal. Up front, anchored by number 73, Mike McLaughlin. Soren Ian All making his 46th consecutive start. This group allowed only 15 sacks. Wide receivers, the Troy Walters story you know about by now. And the other people up there, Deronny Pitts, Russell Stewart, and later in the day, Dave Davis, they're good. Todd Husak, of course, is the man pulling the trigger and very important in the whole scheme of things. They'll go with a running play, and it's going to work for a first down, or very close to it, as Brian Allen, 190-pounder out of Ontario, California, carried it. Jason Doering made the tackle. Wisconsin defense along the front, number 77, Wendell Bryant, very good sophomore, big game here last year. The officials are going to measure, apparently, as they've stopped the clock. The linebacking core for Wisconsin, number 16, Chris Godorzy, leads the team in tackles. Number 19, Roger Knight, is a tough blitzer. In the defensive secondary, number 2, cornerback Jamar Fletcher, has led the Big Ten in interceptions in successive seasons, 7 each year, and 5 of them for touchdowns. And while they are measuring, let me give you the officials. Dennis Hennigan is the referee. Bruce Palmer, the umpire. John McGrath, head linesman. Paul Tide, line judge. Milt Hagen, side judge. Tom Tomczyk, the field judge. Gary Danziewicz, the back judge. And Jack Kramer's the alternate. And they are from the Big East Conference.
And Keith, Mike McLaughlin did get his 46th start of his career for Stanford, but that's about it. He limped to the sideline, and Zach Quascia now has taken over at center. Joe Fairchild moves into that left guard position.
And the ball is on the 35-yard line, first down for the Stanford Cardinal wearing the white uniform. Husak back, passes away in a hurry. Ball is off the hands of Troy Walters. The ball was thrown in such a place that sore right hand had to be the one underneath to make the catch, and he didn't get it.
It's going to be a great battle all afternoon long here. Number 2, Jamar Fletcher for Wisconsin, and Troy Walters. It's his right hand, remember. Fletcher gets away with a little grab there, and that kept Walters from getting the ball. But remember, it's his right hand, and that ball went off his fingertips, did not have the strength to pull it in.
And it's second down and 10. This is Brian Allen losing his balance on some contact from Jason Doering. And Doering is big old safety. He's going to be in their face all afternoon. Count on it as a pickup on the yard of a couple of yards on the play.
And for our Dell Graphic Solutions, our game solutions for Wisconsin, obviously play physical football. Barry Alvarez says that his team's bigger, they're tougher, they're stronger, and they will wear out Stanford.
Jay Bose has come into the backfield on a nickel situation as it's obvious passing down for Stanford on third down and 8. And Todd Husak has changed the play at the line of scrimmage. Drops back and throws. The ball is batted up in the air. The ball was intended for Dave Davis, but it was John Favre, the rush end, who reached up and slapped it away. And so now it brings up fourth down. And here comes what has been this season a weak part of the Stanford football team. Their kicking game has not been all that good. On the other hand, Wisconsin offers you Nick Davis, who is deep as the punt returner, and he's one of the best in the conference, and those numbers right there show you why. The flag is down. The kick is pretty good. Ball is downfield. That'll get a penalty flag because they didn't clear him for the required 2 yards. Randy Fasani came down and hit him, didn't give him the clearance to catch the football. So you got a flag back up here at the 35-yard line, the line of scrimmage. You got a flag down where the contact was made on the attempted reception of the punt.
And the big thing about that graphic we saw, our FedEx team comparison, it's all about field position. And Nick Davis provides field position with his ability to return punts. He has a 71-yard touchdown return this year against Murray State. And he is a big difference maker for Wisconsin. As referees sort this one out.
On the kicking team, the flag for fair catch interference will be disregarded as the player was pushed into the receiving player.
So the Cardinal get a bit of a break on that because Fasani, when he came down and made the contact, was blocked into the receiver. And as a result, that flag is picked up, and the ball will stay down pretty deep where Wisconsin will start its first possession. So So Barry Alvarez grumbling a bit on the call, and we've got timeout in the early going of the Rose Bowl.
AT&T, 7 cents a minute, all day, every day.
Take one of these, that'll be 25 cents.
But it says here it's a nickel.
Not for a couple of hours.
What?
Well, see, sometimes it's a nickel, but right now, it's a quarter.
It's like that long-distance nickel plan where they say it's a nickel.
Sometimes they charge you 25.
That's right.
That's where we got the idea.
Is that right?
7 cents a minute, all day, every day, even to Canada with our international plan.
You know, there are some stores that sell candy for one low price all day long.
And people like it?
Oh, they love it.
Call 1-800-41-RATE to enroll.
Dr. Roger Maxfield's practice is growing fast, which is why he's ready for a professional money manager. The kind he never thought would handle individual portfolios. One of the best money managers is just a few feet away. If only the two could meet. See how we earn it. Solomon Smith Barney.
A pile of 100-year-old bricks might look like rubble to some. But I knew what they'd been through. Knew that you could hardly hurt them. And that bricks with a history like that was strong enough to stand again.
Ford F-Series Super Duty. Built Ford tough.
Tuesday, January 11th at 10, 9 Central.
Remember me?
Blue is back. The season premiere of NYPD Blue, Tuesday, January 11th on ABC.
The end result of the calls a moment ago, the two flags, the one involving the reception of the punt disregarded because the man was blocked into the receiver. The flag back up at the line of scrimmage, illegal formation counted, so the ball comes back and Stanford will re-kick. And Nick Davis is waiting. The punt is away. Not as good as the first one. Sean Tolfenrud, who's had a tough year punting the ball, didn't get all of that one. So Wisconsin, in reality, comes out with a better starting field position. Now the AT&T starting lineup for the Wisconsin Badgers. Along the front, number 75, Chris McIntosh, who's a mountain of a man at 6'7 and 3'10. He's where they go for the hard stuff. The wide receiver core understated here. Number 88, Chris Chambers, very good. Backfield, quarterback Brooke Bollinger's development this year has been a great asset for Ron Dane. He took some of the pressure off Dane, but it's not a big guess as to who gets the ball on the first carry, is it? As Big Ron takes it and hammers it right up the pipe and runs into, guess who? Willie Howard, who's in there playing with an ACL knee. The defense for the Stanford Cardinal is the one that's really under the gun. The people in the front have a chore of considerable dimension. Willie Howard is at defensive end with that sore knee. The linebackers have got to be good today because you can't let Ron Dane get into the secondary. There's nobody back there except the strong safety Tim Smith big enough to take him on. Here's Bollinger on a rollout. The Cardinal defense in full pursuit. Willie Howard and Sharker Steen, and they take him down behind the line of scrimmage.
That's really going to be the key for stopping the rollout and the bootlegs for Wisconsin. Stanford's going to run their linebackers at the quarterback. But having number 77 in the game is the real plus. You can see the brace on his right knee, but you can also see his ability to get into the face of the blocker and make a play on the quarterback.
And he's over there against that great big old 280-pound tight end, Retzlaff. That's why they wanted him in there, and it's now third down and 13. Ball is in the air and long incomplete. Intended for Nick Davis, who, in addition to returning punts for Wisconsin, is also a very good flinker. Defended by Tank Williams, who's making his first start in a long time for Stanford in the secondary.
And after getting 5 yards with Ron Dane on first down, Stanford's defense comes up with a big play on second down, and then Bollinger, not where he's most comfortable in the pocket, overthrows a wide open Nick Davis.
Kevin Stepke is in the punt. He's a good one. He's got a bit of a sore back much of the season. The kick is away. It's a high kick, and it's going to Durrani Pitts on a fair catch call at the 25-yard line. So there the Cardinal will take over, and you go punt, punt. In the first two possessions of the ball game, that punt was 39 yards. There is no score.
Combat Rangers. They're rough. They're tough. They're battle-tested. They're lean, mean fighting machines. When there's a battle to be won, Combat Rangers get the job done. Making backyard safe for democracy.
Now, tell me why they're wearing dresses.
The commander uniforms didn't arrive from China.
That's because you picked the wrong shipping company.
Next time, use the only U.S. Express shipper with direct routes from China, FedEx. Be absolutely sure.
Matching Night Vision Tiara sold separately.
What if your car knew you, anticipated your needs, and then reacted to meet them? What if it could adjust to how long your legs are? What if it could help protect you in an accident? With sensors that know where your seat's positioned and the severity of the crash, so the front airbags can react to you. It's time to stop wondering what if. Introducing the new 2000 Ford Taurus with the advanced personal safety system.
Every morning, the future walks into my classroom. As a teacher, it's my responsibility to empower my students with every advantage. That's why we worked with Dell. Because of Dell's relationships with education software companies, the internet became a learning tool to kindle my students' imaginations. Nothing is more important than giving my students the knowledge they crave. Dell understands that.
Be direct. Dell. Dell desktops use Intel Pentium 3 processors.
The Rose Bowl, presented by AT&T. This ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by AT&T One Rate 7-Cent Plan. One simple rate all day, every day. Ford F-Series. The best-selling trucks are built Ford tough. FedEx. FedEx, be absolutely sure. And ADT. The power that protects more families than any other security company in America.
The 86th Rose Bowl game, presented by AT&T. The weather's getting better as the hours go by on this New Year's Day 2000. First down for the Cardinals from their own 25-yard line. Husak turns and hands the ball off to Corey Wire, who's in at the tailback position, and Wire will pick up maybe 3 yards on the carry. Todd Harris.
Thank you, Keith. Unfortunate news for Stanford. You know, we interviewed Mike McLaughlin earlier this week. He had a streak going where he hadn't missed a start. Well, apparently he'd done more damage that knee earlier in the week. It's a torn ACL. They let him have the start so he keep his streak alive and go out a senior on top. But he is done for the day. The real concern now is the long snapper, John Sandy. They are really going to need him. And Coach Tyrone Willingham is very concerned. Back to you.
Second down and 7 for the Cardinal. Ball is handed off to Troy Wire again. Goes around the left side. He's a tough guy. And he's going to pick up about 3 yards on that carry with Bobby Myers coming up from the safety position to make the play.
What we saw there, though, is a counterplay. And Bill Dietrich, offensive coordinator for Stanford, said that because Wisconsin is very, very disciplined, that allows us to predict what type of defense they're going to be in. So we feel that counterplays are going to be effective. And misdirection, we can look for some reverses, especially to Troy Walters.
You got 4 wideouts on the field now for Stanford on 3rd down and long 3. Husak goes to the sideline. Pass is complete to Troy Walters. 1st down. Cardinal. He caught the ball in front of Jamar Fletcher. Fletcher backed off and gave him a little cushion as Husak came off the snap, and Walters broke the play and stopped just beyond the marker.
And did you see the smile on Troy Walters' face? A smile of relief that he caught the ball. And it's a good catch, too, and he has to use both his hands. Tucks the ball away into his left hand and tries to protect the right hand. Even had to give a high five with his left hand.
Number 11, Joe Borchard, comes into the ball game now at quarterback, and he basically is a single back on the 1st down snap with 4 or 5 wideouts on the field for this play. And Joe, the baseball player, pumps it, takes off up the middle with it, and he's caught from behind. Wendell Bryant got a hold of him as he went by. If Bryant doesn't get him, he's got maybe 10, 12, 15 yards.
He had a 56-yard run against UCLA this year. Might have gone farther, but in his own admission, said he ran out of gas.
Joe's got a decision to make as whether or not he comes back to play football next year, because the anticipation is the baseball folks are going to be bringing a wallet and ringing a cash register in front of him. Second down and eight now. And Husak is back in there. And sack. It's Bryant. Wendell Bryant had a huge game here a year ago against the UCLA Bruins, and he's starting off like gangbusters again. The loss is going to be back to the 33-yard line.
Here he is right here, number 77, his seventh sack of the year. He just beats Joe Fairchild, so you're seeing the effect of Mike McLaughlin out of the game. Fairchild moves into left guard position. Quasha, the normal left guard, is now the center.
And it is third down and 14. Back down as the ball is thrown to the left side, and Kerry Carter showing up in the backfield for the first time. But let's see about the penalty.
Yeah, they killed the play, so this is probably false start against Stanford. That play wasn't going to get the first down anyway.
False start, offense, 5-yard penalty, remains third down.
I'll bet you it's Fairchild. The FedEx Orange Bowl is coming up right after the Rose Bowl game is completed here today, and we're just getting started. That will be a good football game. It's Michigan and Alabama. Two great running backs in that ball game, and two teams that love to run the football. So you might want to make sure your China doors close tightly for that one, because they'll be doing some paint swapping in the Orange Bowl, Alabama and Michigan. Third down now. Husak with time, and now is hit as he throws, and for the first time the penetration came from the inside as Wendell Bryant is finding some daylight in the Stanford offensive blocking.
Boy, they really are. He's from the right side of the screen here. Fairchild turns out on him, but watch Husak trying to find a spot in the pocket, but Bryant just too much for the left side of the Stanford offensive line.
Anthony Gabriel is in to do the snapping, so Sandy, this long snapper, that ball is snapped high, but Topenrud gets it out. It's a good punt. Spinning and carrying to the 34-yard line where Nick Davis makes the fair catch. So Gabriel snapped it high, but Topenrud saved it. Every play starts with the center, and when you lose a guy like McLaughlin, I mean, you have lost a lot. 46 consecutive starts, every start in his entire career. And there's Big Mike. He's big. He occupies a lot of space. So now Wisconsin will go from their 34-yard line, first down. No score in the ball game, first quarter. Time remaining, 8:13. Bollinger turns and gives it to Ron Dane, and Dane's got about 3 yards.
And Keith Ardell, game solutions for Stanford on defense, very, very simple. Kent Barrett, defensive coordinator, says control Ron Dane. You notice the word stop Ron Dane is not in there. Obviously, when a guy averages 6 yards per carry and does most of his damage on first and second down, you don't stop number 33.
He's the single back. He's got the ball. They slow him down behind the line of scrimmage, and they get him. That was good penetration. Austin Lee, number 94, made the tackle, but Willie Howard was in there to mess up the play behind the line of scrimmage.
Another miracle worker, number 77, second guy in here. You see he's jumping right now to the outside. He beats Dake Retzlaff. That's going to be a battle all day long, but that's why Willie Howard has been moved to defensive end, because of his quickness to get in front of Retzlaff and force Dane to cut it back where the linebackers are waiting.
So it is third down and 8. Bollinger back. Hit behind the line of scrimmage, but gets away from that. And he's going to be knocked down just about where the ball was snapped. Sharkus Steen again in on the action. And this time it was Frank Primus firing in to force him.
Kent Bear's going to bring some pressure here. Here is Frank Primus, and he's coming on the corner blitz here. Now, what should happen is Bollinger should throw the release right here. He doesn't get it done, and now there's just no way he can pick up that yardage for the first down.
The snap bounces back to the punter, but it's a beauty from Stepke running Durrani Pitts all the way back to the 11-yard line where he makes the fair catch, and there the Cardinal will have it. First down, Stanford. They're on 11 with no score. 6:09 to go, first quarter.
Did you know that a new 2004 Taurus is being given away with every touchdown scored in every Bowl Championship Series game?
Touchdown!
Call 888-BCS-DRIVE now to enter the Taurus Touchdown Drive sweepstakes and watch Alabama take on Michigan in the FedEx Orange Bowl tonight, only on ABC Sports.
What if your car knew you, anticipated your needs, and then reacted to meet them? What if it could adjust to how long your legs are? What if it could help protect you in an accident? With sensors that know where your seat is positioned and the severity of the crash, so the front airbags react to you. What if it went even further? Wouldn't that make sense? What if it could prevent potential problems? Or light the road better at night? What if its testing exceeded anything the real world can dish out? Is that possible? What if it made genius obvious and brilliance accessible? It's time to stop wondering what if. Introducing the new 2004 Taurus.
I'm going with extra pickles.
Pickles?
I hate pickles.
Onions rule, man.
Give me extra onions, no tomatoes.
Tomatoes are key. I mean, pickles and tomatoes are like the yin and yang of the Whopper.
Look, you get your yin and yang and leave my onions alone, okay?
Okay. But you're wrong.
Hey, it's just a choice.
Yeah, and you choose to be wrong.
Oh, I'm Mike.
And I'm Jack. And that's,
and
my,
that's
Whopper.
My Whopper.
It's my Whopper, and it's my $2.
This is the Rose Bowl, presented by AT&T. The Stanford Cardinals starts this possession from their own 11. The offense has not been dramatic at all so far. They lost their first two centers. And now Gabriel is in there during the snapping. Troy Walters is in the backfield. Now he goes into motion. And the ball is handed off inside to Casey Moore, the fullback, and there is nothing. Casey Moore had a huge play in the big game against California, but he's been pretty quiet since that time. 235-pounder.
In a similar situation against California, he went 94 yards on a straight belly handoff where he outran the secondary of the Cal Bears. But Wisconsin's been looking at tape for a couple weeks now. They know where he's at.
Joe Borchardt's back in at quarterback. Throws quickly to the sideline. Pass is caught, knocked loose, rolls out of bounds. They give him the catch. It's Durrani Pitts hit by Mike Echols, who plays the boundary corner position. Mike Echols from Youngstown, Ohio, is a good one.
And one of the reasons Stanford wants to get Borchardt into the game is he's a great thrower. He's a great quarterback, but he also adds the dimension of running the ball that USAC does not have. When Borchardt gets in the game, especially when they're in the red zone or on the goal line, he likes to run the bootleg, the option, and this quarterback draw.
Third down and a long four now for Stanford. As USAC is back, gets it away quickly, and it is dropped. The pass was on the hands of Russell Stewart, the tight end. He didn't reel it in. Roger Knight, linebacker, covering. He had the yardage for the first down. Ball was where it could be caught, but he didn't do it.
That's a perfect throw by Todd Husak, but Russell Stewart's only caught 10 passes all year. But Stanford saw Purdue go to the tight end a lot in the Purdue-Wisconsin game, so maybe Stewart will get more action.
Now let's see where the drama is on the snap here. Now Now this is a good one. To Tolfin Rude, the punter, roots it out of there. Not a bad kick, but Wisconsin again is going to have pretty good field position as Dick Davis makes a late fair catch call just outside the 35-yard line. Time remaining first quarter, no score, 4 minutes and 36 seconds.
Every year I say, I'm going to quit smoking. Day later, I'm at it again. Till this year. See this? My last piece of Nicorette gum. Been smoke-free with Nicorette now for 12 weeks. With Nicorette, I help control my cravings two ways. I used it on a regular schedule to help curb them. And then for unexpected cravings, I took another piece. And now, no more craving, no more nicotine. Happy New Year.
For a better quit date, you'll have to wait another 1,000 years. You can do it. Nicorette can help.
With the AT&T One Rate 7-Cent plan, calls are just 7 cents a minute all day, every day.
What about Canada?
What?
Canada.
Yeah, same thing. With the international plan, it's 7 cents a minute always.
What about all the other countries in the world?
Japan, Mexico, Liechtenstein.
Liechtenstein.
All right. Every country has its own low rate.
What about France?
France.
France.
Same low rate as France.
Great. I'm going to go call France.
Which is right near France.
7 cents to Canada and great rates around the world. Call 1-800-41-RATE to enroll.
There will be a next one. One who changes the game by control, by speed, by power. The NHL on ABC.
Call now and you can own a copy of the official Rose Bowl game program from today's game. It's the same one sold at the game, and it makes a terrific souvenir. The Sugar, Fiesta, and Orange Bowl programs are also available. Call 1-800-769-8843 now.
You want to join ABC Sports in Atlanta for the Super Bowl? Watch Monday Night Football for all the details this Monday night. But remember, you got to watch to win. Got to change defensively for Stanford. Marcus Hoover, number 92, goes into the ball game, replacing Willie Howard. Let's see what the Badgers do with that change. Now they got a penalty flag first off.
Prior to the snap, ball start, offense, 5-yard penalty, remains first down.
Worth noting, I think, here that it's been 48 days since Wisconsin played a game. They finished their season November 13.
And Keith, a long layoff like that will affect an offense more than a defense. So far for Wisconsin, they've had two possessions, both of them three plays and out.
And it's first down and 15. Chad Coons, fullback. And now we're ready. On first and 15, Bollinger sets under.
Watch it now, watch it now.
Gives to Dane. A little move left, a little move right, then back into the middle. And Tyron Willingham talking about getting ready for this ball game, what to think about, the message to the team, and this is what he said.
Respect and don't fear. Okay, respect them. Good football team, done some great things. But at the same time, don't fear them. We've done some good things, and if we play our game, we become difficult to deal with.
They've been difficult so far. Well, the offense hasn't done much. The defense has stepped up pretty well. Second down, call it 12. Bollinger, a little roll, a little play action, now steps away with pursuit. White shirts are everywhere, and he'll get it back to the 35-yard line, and it's going to be third down and 11. Sharka Steen and Andrew Curry very much involved in that play for the Cardinals.
And again, Sharka Steen recognized the bootleg. Here he is right in the middle. As soon as Bollinger comes out this way, watch Steen come up and force him. Bollinger shows that he's a pretty good runner here. He gets away from Hoover, but there's no way to go to the outside. That forces him back where all the Cardinals are waiting for him.
Now they got trips at the bottom of the screen. Three wide outs at the bottom of the picture. Chris Chambers is the man moving number 88. Bollinger getting a little heat. Now pulls it in and takes off. He's past the line of scrimmage and he's taken down, and Wisconsin will have to punt. Mark Starkbauer ran him down and made the tackle.
You know, Brooks Bollinger is only a redshirt freshman. He's had a great run of seven games. He's 7-0 as a starter. But Stanford is trying to confuse them late at the line of scrimmage, shifting their linebackers, forcing them into obvious passing situations, and the secondary of Stanford's doing a good job. So tough start now for the freshman Bollinger.
Snip, get a punt. Gets it out. Ooh, that's a beauty. Gerardi Pitt circles under it and lets it go. Oh, mistake. Actually didn't make that much difference because Pitt was standing on the 5-yard line and Joey Bose kept the ball from going into the end zone and killed it at the Stanford 2. So Wisconsin's winning the kicking game so far. In our AT&T flashback, we look back to the 1963 Rose Bowl game. That was a matchup between Ron Vanderkellen at quarterback for Wisconsin and Pete Beathard of Southern California. Do you remember it? In the game, number 88, Pat Richter, caught a record 11 passes. Pat is now the athletic director at the University of Wisconsin. And that was a football game that took about 4.5 hours to play. It was one of the longest ever. First down from the 2-yard line. The Trojans won the game, incidentally, 42-37. Out of the end zone now, Stanford in a bit of a pickle here as the big Wisconsin defensive unit swells up and will try to stuff them and get better field position yet. That was Kerry Carter, the bigger of the running backs, a freshman out of Ontario, Canada, making the carry.
So far, Wisconsin has a huge edge as far as average starting position. And with Stanford now starting this drive on the 2-yard line, it's imperative that when Wisconsin gets the ball back, they'll have great field position, but they've got to do something with the ball.
They've got the weapon if they can get him cranked up. You give them the ball on the 35-yard line all day, you're going to get beat.
Ball is up the middle. He's got a man.
It's Troy Walters. First down at the 31-yard line.
Busack is cool. He's calm. He's a competitor. And with the play action fake, he gets enough time to find Troy Walters. Good protection by Stanford. With the play action, they can keep the back in, Kerry Carter, with a man right in his face. Husak throws a perfect ball to Walters. Right in stride, huge first down.
31-yard line. Husak, all the way. That's good for a first down. Complete to Dave Davis, who's a pretty good-sized receiver. Plays bigger than 6 feet. And it's another first down for the Cardinal. That ball was caught in front of Mike Echols.
And what Stanford's trying to do is use a double move against these aggressive corners. Echols is almost as good as Jamar Fletcher. He doesn't go for the out and up fake because he's in a zone coverage. But Davis does a nice job of recognizing he has nothing down the sidelines. Quarterback and receiver on the same page. Another big play for Stanford.
And he moves the football to near the 48-yard line for the Cardinal and the first down. First real movement by either offense so far in the game. Given to Carter. A stand-up run like that's not going to get you much against Wisconsin. It might get you some very sore spots. Aerial coverage for today's program brought to you by AT&T, proud presenting sponsor of this 2000 Rose Bowl game. Second down, 10 for Stanford. Time remaining, 1 minute coming up in the first quarter of play, and no score. Ryan Allen and Casey Moore are the backs lined up behind Todd Husak. Husak still got it. Gets his pass away. Caught. Casey Moore out of the backfield. Makes it another Stanford first down in front of Jason Doering.
And this is as good a catch as you'll ever see any receiver make. Wide receiver, tight end, halfback. But hey, how about a fullback? After the fake, Moore slips into the secondary. A bullet from Husak. And now watch the layout here by Casey Moore. that ball is on Moore just a little bit, he may race all the way into the end zone. Great catch.
Put the ball at the 34-yard line of the Badgers, and first down, Stanford. Ryan Allen, back to you. Usak rolls out, throws the ball to Dewani Fitz. And Dewani Fitz picks up about 11 yards and gets another first down. He picks up more than that. He got close to 13, 14. So put it inside the 20. First down for Stanford at the Wisconsin 17-yard line. Chris Godorzy made the tackle.
And this offense of Stanford is doing a great job of controlling the ball, giving their defense a rest on the sidelines and keeping Ron Dane off the field.
And we're running down to the final seconds of the first quarter. No score, Stanford threatening. ABC Sports presentation of the Rose Bowl, presented by AT&T, returns after this message and the word from our ABC station.
Whoa, cool.
Cool sight?
Cool sight?
Who says cool?
Who says cool?
Cool what?
Cool
what?
What's it cool?
Quotesmith.com.
Quotesmith.com?
It's insurance.
Cool insurance?
Over 300 companies.
I'm hot for this.
Instant is good.
And the best quote is...
Graphics are totally lame.
Yeah, but the quotes will blow you away.
Quotesmith.com. Have you ever said
cool
to insurance?
I have the goosebumps.
Daddy?
Yes, sweetie?
Can the monsters get me?
Not a chance.
When you've got ADT, you've got the power of advanced home monitoring technology.
Good morning, this is Diane.
The power of experienced professionals helping to keep you safe.
Everything okay? Calling the fire department right now.
From burglary, fire, flooding, carbon monoxide, even the occasional monster.
This is Jan with ADT.
Call now and get ADT's sophisticated burglary system installed for as little as $99. Plus, get 2 months free monitoring.
And thank you for choosing ADT.
ADT helps protect more homes and families than any other security company in America. Call now and get the ADT burglary system from $99 installed. Plus, 2 months free monitoring. Sleep tight. Get the power of ADT.
Saturday, New Year's Day, the dawn of a new millennium. Enjoy yourself. Go to the beach. Visit with family and friends. Try a formation skydive or competitive bobsled. Get involved with the running of the Bulls or full contact rugby. Do just about anything, but don't buy a car or truck, because Sunday is Super Sunday at our 13 Autoway AutoNation USA dealerships. A one-day sale so big, we're closed on Saturday to prepare. See you Sunday.
Here's a live look at current conditions from your 24-hour forecast station.
You're watching ABC's coverage of the Rose Bowl, presented by AT&T.
Start of the second quarter here at the Rose Bowl. No score, but Stanford in the midst of a very impressive drive. Their time of possession, as you can see, Wisconsin's had 9 plays in just 12 yards. Ron Dane, 4 carries for 10 yards.
And the cripples have been very obvious for Stanford. Willie Howard and Troy Walters. Usak quickly goes out of bounds. He was trying to get the ball to the Steve Coughlin, who's in there at the tight end position, and Coughlin was blocked away from it and couldn't get upfield under it. Probably, considering the fact that all the white people were caught up in the defensive secondary, Husak made the wise move, threw it away.
Yeah, he's not going to force the ball down here. This is a good drive. That was his first incompletion on the drive. The pass to Walters off the goal line, the key play so far.
Second down and 10. This is Brian Allen, caught behind the line of scrimmage. Good play by Roger Knight, number 19, outside linebacker for Wisconsin. So that's a loss back to the 20-yard line, a loss of 3, and it'll be third down and 13 now for the Cardinals as Wisconsin stiffens.
Knight didn't get as much publicity as the other two linebackers, Thompson and Godorzy, but you can see his quickness as he got inside the blocker there, got deep into the backfield, and then held on for the tackle.
Walters will be at the top of your picture as you look at it. There he is. Cusack gives it to Brian Allen. And Allen breaks it down close to the 11-yard line, but that's still well short of your first down. Remember, they've got to go to about the 7. Jason Doering making the tackle. So it's 4th down coming up, and here comes Mr. Baselli.
And Mr. Automatic inside the 40-yard line where this year, Keith, a perfect 11 for 11.
Mike Baselli, a sophomore from Sparks, Nevada. They're going to spot the football just inside the 19. It'll be a 28-yard field goal try. Gabriel's the snapper, remember. Didn't get it up very well, but he got the kick away, and he made it. Woo. I'm not sure I'd want to be holding that one because Baselli was going to kick that ball. It didn't make any difference. And your starting quarterback is the one trying to hold that hot snap. But it works, and Stanford leads.
Net service. Just click and go.
Dodge Dakota brings you a startling new advancement. Doors, great big ones, on the driver's side and the passenger side, each with windows that go all the way down. So what's the big deal about two great big wide opening doors? Nothing. But four is a different story. Real truck, real doors. Dodge Dakota Quad Cab. Different.
Hey, neighbor. Can I borrow some ice?
Yeah, sure. Hold this.
Yep. Thanks. Got any sugar? Toothbrush? Hair dryer?
Hey.
With more barbecue and cheddar flavor you can see, more you can taste on every chip and every bite. New Ruffles Flavor Rush potato chips keep you coming back for more.
The Rose Bowl presented by AT&T, Pasadena, California, and let's go back to that field goal and watch the speed of that ball coming back.
This is in real time, and the quarterback, as you said, the holder is the quarterback, Todd Husak, and he might have lost a fingernail or two on that one.
Handled it well, though, and Baselli just nailed it. Here's the kickoff by Baselli, driving it all the way into the end zone. Wow, 4 yards deep. Nick Davis is coming out. Runs into the zone man. That slows him down, and he'll go down at about the 15-yard line. Now time for the Aflac trivia question. Which was the last non-Big Ten or Pac-10 team to play in the Rose Bowl? Do you remember? Very famous college football team. So here comes Wisconsin, who's gone little so far in the offense portion of the game, trailing 3-0. Starting from the 15-yard line, Dane bounces outside, finds daylight, big run by Ron, and he's up to about the 35-yard line. Frank Primus and Mark Stockbauer. You never give up. You never relax with this guy on the field. He'll tear you up.
And very determined. Looked to be a little bit frustrated here. Breaks the tackle of Tim Smith. That's not a good sign for Stanford. The straight arm on Primus, who just gets one of the shoelaces to bring down Dane after 20 yards.
That is the initial first down for the Wisconsin Badgers. Now we're going back to the kind of football game that Barry Alvarez likes to play. Physical game, big offensive line, and a big old 255 tailback. 55-pound tailback beating on you. goes back to the glory days of the student body right and left when John McKay was at Southern California, when he would say first quarter 3 yards, second quarter 5, third quarter 10, fourth quarter touchdown.
And he said the ball only weighs what, 13 ounces? They shouldn't get tired carrying something that light.
One of the big reasons that offensive front moves, of course, is that big fella, number 75, McIntosh. It's a quarterback draw they were trying to run there, and Stanford didn't buy it. And Bollinger's brought down by Willie Howard. Now here's Todd Harris.
Well, Keith, you're talking about big Chris McIntosh. He is quite a performer. Now, after the team lost badly back in 1998's Outback Bowl, they had a team meeting, and he stood up and said, you know what, I didn't come to Wisconsin to go to the Outback Bowl. I came here to go to the Rose Bowl. And here he is 2 years in a row.
There's the co-MVP of this Badger team, along with Ron Day, number 75, Chris McIntosh, a surefire first-round pick in the NFL draft.
39-yard line. Third down, six. Bollinger looks to the left side, gets his man, completes it to Chris Chambers, number 88. Chris Chambers is a junior out of Bedford, Ohio, and he's working on that play against Chris Johnson, number 29 in at corner for Stanford.
And Bollinger showing his maturity, throwing to his favorite receiver. And I know I could tell you he's his favorite receiver because he's caught four of his last five touchdown passes have come from Brooks Bollinger. So Bollinger's looking for number 88.
Put the ball at the 48-yard line and a first down. That's Dane to the 50. Pick up of two. Well, Wisconsin needs to get some air going here, Dan, because that'll open it up for Ron Dane.
Well, the thing about Wisconsin they talk about now with the emergence of Bollinger as a quarterback is it's opened up not only Dane, but it's helped Chambers as well.
And next year they're going to add Michael Bennett to the mix because he's going to be in the backfield with Dane leaving, and he's out there right now, but he's out there as a wide receiver. Number 29, Michael Bennett, he's a burner out of Milwaukee. Bollinger back, going deep down the middle. He's got Chambers, and he makes the catch. First down, Wisconsin, inside the Stanford 15-yard line. He got away from Reuben Carter.
By bringing Bennett around on the reverse fake from the left side of the screen, you'll see it. It affects the middle of the secondary for Stanford. There's nobody in the middle of the field. Bollinger lays it out there, and look at Chambers with a 5-yard lead on Carter, and just an outstanding effort to bring that ball in. Look at how he protects it from hitting the ground.
35-yard gain, first down at the Stanford 15-yard line for the Badgers, their first threat of the ball game. Give it to Ron Dane, and he'll get out just about the line of scrimmage.
But a totally different Badger football team, and it all started with that 20-yard run by Ron Dane. He personally jump-started this offense.
Andrew Curry made that last tackle, number 99, for Stanford. Number 41, Chad Coons, comes off the field, the fullback. Gives to Dane. Penalty flag on the field. Stockbauer, the first man to get a hold of Dane as he crosses the line of scrimmage. And let's see about the penalty flag. It's against Wisconsin.
Brooks Bollinger, after he took over, you know, you look at the obvious here with the record and the total yards, but it's this one right here. 21-point difference with Brooks Bollinger as the starting quarterback.
Penalty is declined. Third down.
So they take the down. It brings up third and nine, and declining a 5-yard penalty on the illegal shift, and leaves the football at the 14-yard line. And they've got a very good place kicker in Vitaly Pozetsky, and now timeout is called, and called quickly. 9:26 to go in the first half of play. Wisconsin threatening against Stanford's 3-0 lead.
Well, when I got hurt in this work, glad I had supplemental insurance.
Supplemental insurance? What's that?
Aflac.
Well, even best insurance doesn't give you cash to cover things like lost pay, other expenses. This does.
What does?
Aflac.
Shouldn't ask about it at work.
Really? And what's it called?
Aflac!
Aflac. Without it, no insurance is complete.
Aflac.
This is the workshop of radicals. A one-car garage where two young men with $500 in venture capital invented an industry. Their idea was simple. Invent something useful and significant, or it doesn't leave the garage. The idea was so simple, it was radical. Today, the company of Bill Hewlett and Dave Packard is being reinvented. The original startup will act like one again. Watch.
New Dakota Quad Cab comes with a nice big bed and big back doors that lead to a great big cab for putting things you don't want outside, inside, and vice versa. Inside, outside, inside, outside, inside, outside, inside, oops, that's better, outside. Dodge Dakota Quad Cab. Big room, big doors, big difference.
Presented by AT&T. This ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by AT&T One Rate 7-Cent Plan. One simple rate all day, every day. Dodge. In a perfect world, everything would be different. New Tostitos Snack Kits. A whole new way to dig in, kick back. And Nicorette Gum. You can do it. Nicorette can help.
Want to thank AT&T, proud presenting sponsor of the 2000 Rose Bowl game, for coverage in the air of today's ball game. Pilot Mark Grebbins, and the cameraman is Greg Johnson. Now it is third down and 9. Ball is on the 14-yard line. Wisconsin trying to keep it going and grab the lead. Bollinger's pass is thrown in. Complete, making the play against Nick Davis. Reuben Carter, the man who got burned on the long 35-yard gain by Chris Chambers, but he was there this time.
Carter may have got away with a little bit of a hold there, but Davis has got to make that catch. He was falling down, but he still had two hands up on that ball. Bollinger threw it where he had to, and Carter got away with a little bit of a grab.
31-yard field goal try now from Vitaly Pizetsky, who came from the Soviet Union to a football career at Wisconsin. Kick is up, a lot of leg on it, and it's good. And at 9 minutes and 19 seconds to play in the first half, we're even at 3.
Nokia, we've discovered our phones are a lot like pets. They somehow seem to resemble their owners. Nokia. Connecting people.
You're watching ABC Sports coverage of the Rose Bowl presented by AT&T.
Tomorrow night, the BCS continues on ABC. Eric Crouch and Big 12 champion Nebraska going against Tennessee's T. Martin and company. That's a couple of pretty good quarterbacks in that ball game. It'll be 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC tomorrow, part of Super January. High long kick back to the 7-yard line. Return to Ryan Wells. And Wells comes up across the 20 near the 24. There the Cardinal will go to work. A 3-3 ball game. And here's the answer to your Aflac trivia question. Which non-Big Ten Pac-10 team, the last time a non-Big Ten Pac-10 team played here, and it was Alabama. The Alabama Crimson Tide led by Harry Gilmer. And Gilmer, when he couldn't find a place to run, would jump up in the air and whistle a bullet. And that bunch of freshmen, this, remember, was right at the end of the war. In 1946, came out and won decisively over Southern California. Alabama spent a lot of time in Pasadena back in the day. Good play by the Wisconsin defender, Roger Knight. That's the second really big play that Knight has made, because Troy Walters was behind him and had some room.
And he shows his versatility with this play. We saw him making a play in the backfield, but this is in pass coverage, and this is where Knight is so important for Wisconsin, especially in this game against Stanford. He has the ability to almost give Wisconsin an extra defensive back.
Second down and 10. Ball is just short of the 24-yard line. Todd Husak having a pretty good ball game. Hands it off inside, goes to Coy Wire, and not much. The middle of that Wisconsin defensive front is pretty sticky. You run into the likes of Janik and Malik and Bryant, Balaji and Sprague. They make you sore. It'll be third down and 9.
Stanford's been trying to hit the middle of that Wisconsin defensive line with just single back. If they're going to do that, they're going to have to get a fullback in front of the tailback.
You got Walters in pitch now as the wideouts. Pressure coming on Husak. The ball is away. Thrown to Brian Allen, and there's a very decisive tackle by Jason Doering on Brian Allen, and Stanford will punt. Jason Doering is 202 pounds. He's out of Rhinelander, Wisconsin, and he is a tough guy.
And what he did is he took the place of the cornerback. Here is Echols. He's coming on the blitz, so that means Doering, as a safety, has to come out and pick up the back, Brian Allen, and he did a great job.
Punt is away by Tolfin Rood. Gets it up. Gets it to turnover. Pretty good kick. Fair catch to Nick Davis. Davis handling that high floating kick very well. It'll be put down at the 29-yard line, a 46-yard punt.
It is more than a trial by fire. It is a rite of passage. And if you can master your fear, outsmart your enemy, and never yield even to yourself, you will be changed forever. The few, the proud, the Marines.
ABC Sports is online at ESPN.com, part of the GO Network. ...29-yard line after a very fine 46-yard punt by Tolford Root, rooting the Cardinal out of jam here and keeping Wisconsin inside its 30-yard line. And here they come now. Brooks Bollinger sets them down. Dane's the deep man. Ron Dane has the ball. He's running behind Chad Coon. And Coon leads him to the line of scrimmage, and then the big fella pounds on up for about 5 yards, maybe 6 yards. Sharkus Steen, who's a 235-pound linebacker out of Etowanda, California, makes the tackle. Ron Dane is fun to be around. I'm beginning to understand, the more I've seen of him the last couple of weeks, he's a very easy fellow to be around. His teammates really like him. Out of Berlin, New Jersey, a Heisman Trophy winner.
Did a great job of handling all that Heisman hype, too, in the entire year. And especially back in New York, was happy to get back to practice.
That's up to the 40 and across it, and that's a first down. Sharkus Steen making another tackle.
Ron Dane proved to everybody last year in the Rose Bowl that he's just not a power runner. This 54-yarder against UCLA, he showed he has the speed to run away from the secondary and then the moves to make the secondary miss and get in the end zone.
That was a year ago. Right now, Dane is out, and Michael Bennett is into the ball game. The ball is at the 41-yard line where it's first down, and Bollinger runs away from the pressure, gets it off downfield. He's got a man wide open. Bennett missed the ball. Michael Bennett missed the ball. There's a penalty flag back near where the ball was thrown. Willie Howard, Bill Ferrario were involved. Well, let's see how the call goes. Ah, it's against Wisconsin, clipping.
And it's on Ferrario, blocking against Willie Howard.
That's kind of scary. Willie's out there with an ACL knee as it is.
Well, let's take a look at it. 77 is Howard. Ferrario is going to come from the other side of the formation, number 60 right here. He can't catch up to him. That's a good call. Block in the back, clipping. And Willie Howard's real lucky he didn't re-injure that right knee.
Clipping on the offense. 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Repeat first down.
That's a huge penalty.
From the spot of the foul, really moves it way, way back there. The key on that play, Willie Howard still has the speed, even with that bad knee, to get out there and contain the quarterback. Much too fast for Bill Ferrario.
25-yard penalty. Ball now sits at the 16-yard line, where it's first down and 35, and Ron Dane is back. And has the ball. And does not get to the line of scrimmage because Tim Smith, he is the only man in that defensive secondary really big enough to take him on. Smith is 230 pounds at 6'4", and Tim came up to make the tackle.
And that's what Stanford wants to do, is get Tim Smith involved in the run defense, get him up to the line of scrimmage. They're trying to shift both their inside linebackers, Mark Stockbauer and Sharkus Steen, to the strong side, because Wisconsin, with Dane running behind that big offensive line, like to give him a lot of the options, let him stretch the defense and then cut back.
Dane is out. Daniels is in. Carlo Daniels. Bollinger rolls it out. Pressure coming. Going to be, gets the ball away and throws it into the crowd. Stanford almost had a sack on him back near the goal line. Austin Lee, number 94, led that defensive charge. So that Stanford Cardinal defense, about which millions of words have been written, playing pretty well right now.
And most of those millions of words have been bad words.
Yeah.
But you can see Lee, similar to what Willie Howard did on the play previous, with the containment on the quarterback, and then after reading the bootleg, Sharkus Steen is going and attacking the line of scrimmage and forcing Bollinger to throw the ball away in that case.
Ball is at the 15-yard line. It is third down and 36. Carlos Daniels. Carlos is to the outside. Michael Bennett, 29, not 39. And Stockbauer makes the hit on him, and they'll punt.
Shows you just how critical that penalty against Bill Ferrario was. You know, from a near touchdown reception by Bennett to a first and 25, and now an impossible situation, a third and 37.
Deronnie Fitz deep for this man, Kevin Stempke's punt. No pressure on Stempke. Liner, Fitz might have a little room, bobbled it though, and he's still working at it. And he puts the ball back on the Wisconsin side of the field. Takes it down to about the 46-yard line before Bobby Myers finally tracked him down. So Deronnie Fitz, nobody wrapped him. He took the hit, shook it off, and had a nice return out of it of 13 yards. Tonight, right behind us, comes the FedEx Orange Bowl from Lourdes. Brad Nessler, Bob Greasy, Lynn Swan will be down there covering that one for you. Sean Alexander, the big running back for Alabama. Mr. Thomas for Michigan. Two teams that love to run the football and play defense. That's at 8:30 Eastern, 5:30 Pacific, part of the Bowl Championship Series. Kerry Carter is in the backfield. Husak keeps the ball and will run it. And will pick up about 8 yards. He was knocked out of bounds by Donnell Thompson, and a penalty flag followed them.
Yeah, actually, he stepped out of bounds, and then Thompson came with the hit. And he was only about 2 yards out of bounds, which is 2 yards too much. Donnell playing with a bad left ankle, maybe not having the speed to get him before he goes out of bounds. Now he's going to get the big penalty.
It'll be a 15-yarder.
A little razzle-dazzle for Stanford. They fake the reverse to Walters there, and then Husak does what he normally doesn't do. He doesn't run the ball that often. There's the hit out of bounds, and the flag comes flying. Watch Husak. He's looking for that first down marker. Decides to go out of bounds. That's a good call by the official.
Dennis Hennigan is the referee. They are out of the Big East Conference. Deronnie Fitz and Troy Walters are the wideouts, and Wisconsin knows sooner or later they're going to give that reverse to Walters.
Faked it a couple times already in the first half.
Stanford threatening again. Husak back down the middle. It goes, and it's caught by Walters at the 3 yard line, right in front of Jamar Fletcher.
My play action pass has been very good for Stanford today, which is kind of surprising because they're not running the ball worth a lick. But it's giving Husak good pass protection. After the fake to Kerry Carter, you're going to see Walters come in from the right side of the screen in front of Jamar Fletcher. It's zone coverage by Wisconsin. Ball thrown low, so Walters doesn't have to expose his body or that bad right hand. He can cradle the ball. But did he catch it? Looked like it hit the ground.
It's a catch. They're snapping it down there. And Joe Borchard's in at quarterback. And he turns and gives the ball to Kerry Carter, the big back, and Carter at 225 gets nothing on that play. That was a pass play of 19 yards that Walters caught.
And aren't we glad that we are college football and we don't have to worry about interrupting the flow of the game by having the official go over and look into a camera as they do in that other league?
Oh, he caught it.
He caught the ball there. He's down. Then the ball comes loose. That's a good call. Borchard comes into the game on the goal line to give Stanford the ability to run the option, the bootleg, and also the quarterback draw. He scored against Notre Dame on a naked bootleg in the last game.
The strong-legged fellow, Coy Wire, is in there at the tailback position right now. And Borchard keeps it, throws it into the end zone, and throws it away. Russell Stewart was back in the back of the end zone, but Borchard couldn't see him because there was a man defending against him, and he threw it away.
We got a flag in the end zone, too, Keith.
Might be
Doring may be holding. This is against Notre Dame. Watch as Borchard comes out here. There's no help. But there is also nobody from Notre Dame. Very easy touchdown for Joe Borchard.
Here's the call on the flag of the end zone.
Holding on defense. The defense. Penalty is half the distance to the goal. Automatic first down.
Holding on the defense. Automatic first down. And that'll put the ball about a yard and a half away from the Wisconsin goal line.
And Keith, it was Jason Doring holding Russell Stewart. Watch him right here. He's trying to get to the corner of the end zone, number 84. There's the grab by Doering. Borchardt with a heady shot is throwing it out of the back of the end zone, getting the flag. Borchardt keeps it, turns inside. Close. No call. Gordorzy there to get him. It's at the one. Second down and goal.
I think Borchardt made up his mind a little bit too early there, but you really can't blame him when the ball is so close to the goal line. But if he's a little bit more patient on that option and pitches the ball back, Stanford has an easy touchdown.
Cusack threading on the sidelines. Second down and goal. Borchardt to the fullback, and that won't get it. That's right down at the line of scrimmage. Casey Moore never really had a chance to move the stack. Somebody came low and locked him early.
That's one of those misdirection plays that Stanford thought that they could be successful with against Wisconsin. But again, every time they give the ball to the running back, just a single running back with no blocker in front of them, they have gotten absolutely nothing.
They got Kerry Carter in there now. He's the bigger of the backs. He's the freshman. And it's third down and goal from the one. Carter. He made it. Touchdown, Stanford. He bounced off the first hit by Thompson and slid into the end zone.
And he had a lead blocker in front of him. And I think that, along with that big size you talked about, Keith, is why he gets into the end zone. Casey Moore is in front of him, number 33. Watches a hit off the right side. Good kick out block there. There's the block by Moore. There's the touchdown.
Baselli for the point. Snapping troubles. Mike McLaughlin, John Sandy, who is the snapper on circumstances like this, the points and field goals. Anthony Gabriel playing in his relief. And so that's the second time Gabriel has had a bad snap. Here's another look at the touchdown as we go to break. 2:03 to play in the first half. Stanford Legion, 9-3.
I'm not doing anything tonight, so call me.
Grabbing Bud Light.
Boys, this is my lucky. What is this, a 5 or 6?
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down.
Is it a 5 or 6?
Make it a Bud Light.
That's a 4. That's
definitely a B.
4,
definitely.
Maybe an F.
Before I quit smoking, I asked my doctor, is Nicorette safe? And he said, of course Nicorette is safe. Smoking is not. Nicorette has been proven safe and effective in dozens of clinical trials. And Nicorette offers the Committed Quitter Support Program, which my doc said is clinically proven to increase my chances of success by up to 50%. And when he told me that only Nicorette comes in mint, I knew that that was the right choice for me. So I took my doctor's advice, and you know what? It worked.
You can do it. Nicorette can help.
Sunday, January 9th. The phenomenon is back.
He's won $1 million.
Who Wants to Be a Millionaire returns Sunday, January 9th on ABC.
The Nokia Sugar Bowl has gone interactive with ABC's Enhanced TV. Get real-time stats and more while you watch the game. Log on to ESPN.com or ABC.com Tuesday, January 4th. For the BCS National Championship game. Low driving kickoff. Bobbled around in the end zone, and Nick Davis will put it down and bring it out to the 20, where it'll be first down Wisconsin. Now let's join John and Terry in New Orleans and a check on what's at halftime.
Well, Keith, as you can see, the sun has begun to set here on another day in New Orleans. And if you're the players on Florida State and Virginia Tech, they can't set fast enough. They want to play.
Yeah, we wondered how this atmosphere would affect the players. Corey Moore blows up in a press conference yesterday. Two players of FSU late for curfew. The coaches want this game played now.
Yeah, it will be played on Tuesday. We'll talk about that and have scores and highlights from around the day. It's all coming up on the National Car Rental halftime report. Right now, let's get back to Keith in Pasadena.
And on the first down snap, Bollinger runs away from the pressure, trying to get to the outside. Got one good block, and now he gets to the sideline. He's going to pick up about 5 or 6 yards. Ron Dane was the man that threw the block. That kept him from being dropped well back of the line of scrimmage. I would think that the boys have probably seen a few distractions in New Orleans.
Around the New Year's, yeah, especially this New Year's.
Yes. The opportunity is certainly there. Second down and three. Passes to the sidelines and good to Chris Chambers for a first down. A minute and 42 seconds as he goes out of bounds to stop the clock, remaining in the first half of play.
One thing Stanford defensively is doing during this drive, they've moved Willie Howard back inside as a tackle and made Rial Johnson a defensive end, so they're getting more speed. Johnson had 17 tackles for a loss this year, including 13 sacks.
I think it's amazing the way Willie Howard's playing. I cannot believe he's out there with a torn ACL. There he is.
Yep.
On first down, Bollinger. Lee's after him. Runs away from him and throws. It's out of bounds. That pass was out of bounds. Nick Davis was the intended receiver, and Nick had his hands on it. Primus was right there with him. But even if he'd caught it, it wouldn't count.
And you know, it was dangerously close to Coach Barry Alvarez on the sidelines.
Yep.
Here's Barry right here. It's remember, scary. He's got a cane there. And he does not have the ability to get out of the way. You can see how wrapped up that right knee is, but there's nothing wrong with his vocal cords.
Well, there's some feeling he made the catch, I think. That's what it is.
Can't yell like that from the press box.
He's feisty, boy. Second down and 10. Going big, down the middle. It's incomplete, intended for Davis. Davis had double coverage that time. Running with him was Primus and Tank Williams. Barry Alvarez played for Bob Devaney at Nebraska and started his coaching career in Nebraska. And to this day, talks so fondly of Bob Devaney, not only as a man and a coach, but of the philosophy. And a lot of Devaney's philosophy is in this Wisconsin program.
Wanted to do just like Devaney did, build a program and sustain it. He says we are in the sustain mode now.
I should say, three Rose Bowls in a decade. Bollinger back, looking deep, going deep, down the sidelines, and Chambers can't track it down. Now you've got a minute and 23 to play in the first half, and it's fourth down. So the Badgers try to make something happen with a long ball, doesn't work, and they'll punt.
Keith, and now this is where Stanford's very dangerous with their passing game and with Troy Walters in the game. They've got all three of their timeouts remaining, and they should get decent field position.
Derani Fitz is waiting for Stemski's punt. Stemski can kill it sometimes. So let's see here. Now, Fitz will take a shot at it. He runs right into a Wisconsin man at the 30, falls forward to the 31. Bose making the tackle. And there, Stanford will go to work.
Keith, you were amazed at Willie Howard playing. This is equally as amazing. Troy Walters in the first half showing nil ill effects of that dislocated right wrist. And this one got him down in great field position where they took it in for the touchdown.
Dave Davis is in there now, number 81, as a wideout. Eddie Gales, number 21, is on the field. He's another speed burner. And they go out of the shotgun. Usak's pass thrown quickly to Dave Davis. Davis can do things with the ball after he catches it, but he was pushed out of bounds there by Bose. And a moment with Todd Harris.
Well, Keith, Dave Davis may be the master of T-shirts. You know, he's the guy that started up the 1T plus 1G equals 1B. That's one team plus one goal equals one bowl. Well, his latest one, on the front of the shirt, says, they picked us to finish eighth in the Pac-10. Do you believe that? We didn't. Some of the guys in the Speed Corps are wearing those shirts today.
Another entrepreneur from Stanford. Second down, seven. A lot of those guys around, I'll tell you.
That's good for a first down and then some. Devontae Fitz. And Fitz will take him down to about the 41, 42-yard line. And a penalty flag was thrown back around the 30-yard line. So let's see about that. All that excitement might be for naught. Holding on the offense. You've got 56 seconds left to play in the first half now. Stanford leading Wisconsin by a score of 9-3. That negated, according to Mark Amento, 24-yard pickup. Kelly Hayes has come down off the mountain to spend the
holding
New Year's Day with us.
On the offense, 10-yard penalty from the line of scrimmage. Repeat second down.
It was, some of the people that went to the Rose Parade this morning, Dan, said it was cold.
Well, as I was driving back from your house last night after a wonderful dinner, there were people camped out here. Here's the hold right here by Jeff Kronshagen. That allowed USAC to get this ball off and negates a big play. But again, it's that running ability after the catch.
Yep. They do it well. Second down and 17 now. USAC turns and hands the ball away, and there's a further loss on the play. Eddie Gales had no chance. Wendell Bryant just ate him up.
And even with the timeout, Stanford, after that penalty, they're going to just take this one to the house and go in at halftime, happy to be up with a six-point lead over the heavily favored Badgers. Now Wisconsin says they want timeout. They want to get a shot and get the ball back.
Well, they've got Nick Davis, who's one of the best kick return guys in the country. I don't blame him. I would, too. 16 seconds remains to play.
Pac-10 women's basketball, where the stars of today and tomorrow play. The best schools, the best coaches, the best players, the best fans, the best basketball. Pac-10 teams are proven winners. Four NCAA titles, 53 All-Americans, 21 players in the WNBA, and poised to produce much more of the same in the next millennium. Come check out the excitement. Pac-10 women's basketball, the one to watch.
Great moments in college sports make great memories and often inspire great achievement beyond the game. Come see it all at the Hall, the new NCAA Hall of Champions, a place to relive the action, savor the memories, discover what it means to be a true champion, and that might be the greatest moment sports has ever produced. The NCAA Hall of Champions, opening in downtown Indianapolis in March 2000.
There's Willie Howard getting, he's putting ice on himself and holding on to his chain. What do you call them? The Trench Dogs. Stanford was here in 1972, 71, 72. They had the Thunder Chickens. Today they got a dancing tree. 21-yard line, third down and 20, 16 ticks remaining on the clock. They'll take this snap. Try to run it out. There's a penalty flag down as Kerry Carter runs into Wendell Bryant, and he gets out to about the 25-yard line, and Wisconsin jumps all over it again to stop the clock. Now they've got 11 seconds, and they'll have to punt it.
Willie Bryant saying, or Wendell Bryant, rather, saying, I was offside,
yep.
Coach.
Taking the blame. Offside is the 5-yard penalty.
By the defense, 5-yard penalty, repeat third down.
That could mean, I don't believe, though, in my wildest imagination, that Stanford will put the ball in the air. But if they could break a run here. And they're not going to have to because the clock. And Stanford lead. Score of 9-3. After the first half of play. Now let's go to John and Terry, New Orleans, for the National Car Rental Halftime Report.
All right, Keith, thanks a lot. The second half still to come, and it's good to see that Barry Alvarez, his knee is allowing him to be on the sidelines. But right now, the way the game's going, you might want to hit for the press box again.
That's right, because Stanford's best defense against Wisconsin is their offense. They're scoring points and keeping Ron Dayne on the sideline, too.
9-3 is the score. When we come back, we will take you back out to Pasadena for more of the pageantry from the Rose Bowl presented by AT&T.
Ladies and gentlemen, your starting 5'7'1", Patrick Ewing. 6'11", Marcus Camby. 6'7".
They forgot to change the floor again.
Now there's a whole new way to snack and kick back. Introducing single-serving Tostitos snack kits. Just be sure you pick the right time to eat them. Dig in, kick back, Tostitos.
Ewing, live to the hoop.
You never know what surprises the holidays will bring. That's why Farmers Insurance is all about getting things back to normal. Isn't that what insurance is supposed to do? Farmers, get you back where you belong.
January 9th, on an all-new practice, a controversial client fires up a lawyer's passion.
1.6 times a week. Last year, it was 3.9. I need more sex.
An all-new practice returns ABC Sunday, January 9th.
You do the math.
It's okay. It's not a live animal. It's not the shoes that you wanted.
The Lexus, December to remember sales event.
Honey, you gotta see this.
Okay.
You'll find values you never believed possible.
You like it?
The December to remember sales event ends January 3rd. Missing it would definitely spoil the surprise. See Lexus of Clearwater and Lexus of Tampa Bay, Tampa.
Here's a live look at current conditions from your 24-hour forecast station.
This is the National Car Rental Halftime Report, brought to you by National Car Rental, the official car rental company of the Bowl Championship Series. Now, from New Orleans, here's John Saunders and Terry Bowden.
Happy New Year's to everyone. It's New Orleans. It's New Year's. It's a celebration, as you might expect. Terry rejoins me in just a moment. But right now, out to Pasadena and the pageantry, let's rejoin Keith Jackson. Keith.
The Grand Marshal of Rose Bowl number 86. Presented by AT&T is Mr. Roy E. Disney, and the Queen, Sophia Bush, 17-year-old senior at Westridge School, lives here in Pasadena, California. And out on the field right now, mayhem, chaos, the Stanford Band, directed by Scott Stanford. And if there's anybody anywhere in the world who has more fun than these people, I don't know who they are. Out there today and having fun with him is a fellow named Gary Tyrell, 38 years of age, a management accounting consultant. He was involved. Remember when California ran down the field and ran through the Stanford Band for that momentous moment in college football? Well, he was the guy that got run over. And he...
college football games. But who else as well? In the Citrus Bowl, the Spartans beat the Gators 37-34. The Spartans haven't had a battle like that since the Peloponnesian War.
The Stanford Band at the Rose Bowl. We'll be back with more of the National Car Rental Halftime Report after these messages.
Speed. That's what business is all about. How fast can you zap your email? How fast can you zap your competitors? How fast can you eat your breakfast? How fast can you eat your competitors' lunch? To the business traveler, it's all about speed. That's why you should join National Car Rentals Emerald Club. You get to bypass the counter, go straight to the Emerald Isle, take the car of your choice, and go. National calls it Emerald Club, but you'll call it a great way to rent a car. One fast world, one very fast car rental company. Let's go!
At the beginning of the 21st century, Stanford University has become a world-renowned center of teaching, learning, and research. Stanford is a leader in science, law, medicine, business, and the humanities. Its scholars have won 5 Nobel Prizes since 1995. In the age of information, Stanford believes the university's success will be in teaching students to be flexible.
The best college education these days is education that will make it possible for the students to cope with the new knowledge and the new information that comes to them when they have graduated from college.
Academics are matched in quality on the playing field. For the 5th year in a row, Stanford has been awarded the Sears Cup for the best collegiate athletic program in America.
Got it. We got it. Going to the road.
Stanford, producing winners in the classroom, winners on the field.
Sometimes people are afraid to admit that they don't know what their life's plan is. This is the one time in your life where you can read great books, learn about the great thinkers, challenge yourself, and say, all I want to do is gain a broad liberal arts humanities background. It's the perfect way to go into something like the field I'm in, because you learn to think critically, and I apply that every day to what I do here. I absolutely wouldn't trade it for the world. I owe that to my experience when I was an undergraduate at the University of Wisconsin.
Welcome back to the National Car Rental Halftime Report. Here in New Orleans, the only battle that's being decided early, because the game's not till Tuesday, is whose fans are the most rowdy right now?
I tell you, if performance on Bourbon Street makes any difference, the Virginia Tech Hokies are killing the Florida State faithful.
And on the field, we will find out on Tuesday. What a great game we had earlier today here on ABC in the OurHouse.com Florida Citrus Bowl. Michigan State, Bobby Williams making his debut as the head coach, and it was tied up until this. Paul Edinger with a game-winning field goal as time expires and Michigan State knocks off Florida. Bobby Williams wins the bowl game in his coaching debut, the 6th coach to do that. And boy, he caught up with our Jackaroo and was excited after the game.
Well, you are drenched. How special is this for you, coach?
This is a very, very big win for Michigan State University. You see these kids right here? This is for them. These coaches, these players, hell of an effort. And all these fans right here, they're the greatest fans in college football. Hell of a win. I love you, man. Happy New Year, man.
Happy New Year.
Right now, Bobby Williams loves everyone with that victory. In the Cotton Bowl, Texas knocked off by Arkansas. 27-6. Cedric Cobbs, 15 carries for 98 yards and a touchdown. In the Outback, this is the greatest comeback in the history of any college bowl. Purdue had a 25-0 lead. Georgia wins it in overtime, 28-25. And Miami against Georgia Tech, the Big East against the ACC, like in the national championship game. The Big East gets the victory in that one. Don't forget, coming up later tonight on ABC, 8:30 Eastern time, the FedEx Orange Bowl, Michigan and Alabama.
You know, if these two great tailbacks cross each other out, then look at Freddie Millen's, the Peter Warwick-like receiver at Alabama, to be the difference in this football game.
These two teams played the toughest schedules in college football. Michigan number two, Alabama was number one. That one should be a great game tonight in the FedEx Orange Bowl. That's coming up after the Rose Bowl, presented by AT&T. Back there for more pageantry in a moment.
National Car Rental welcomes you and your family to a magical experience. The year-long Walt Disney World Millennium Celebration. And as the official car rental company of the Walt Disney World Resort, National gets you to this unforgettable celebration fast. Don't miss this momentous occasion and all the memories that go with it. Let's go to the Walt Disney World Millennium Celebration with National Car Rental.
How to dream.
I love you guys.
You can help her dream big.
Woo-hoo! Oh, yeah! They're killing me.
Someday, there will be no Alzheimer's. At the University of Wisconsin-Madison, we're searching for the cause. Someday, we'll treat childhood genetic diseases before a single symptom appears. And someday, chronic depression will be a thing of the past because of what we're learning today. The University of Wisconsin-Madison. It's going to be a great century.
The people of AT&T join me in wishing you and your family a happy new year. And we're delighted to kick off the new century by bringing you this telecast of the year 2000 Rose Bowl game.
Tuesday, January 11th at 10, 9 Central.
You sit down and you don't even think about moving. Remember me?
Blue is back. The season begins January 11th on ABC. Viewer discretion advised.
Fans on the lazy Mississippi awaiting the national championship game in the Nokia Sugar Bowl. They have to wait till Tuesday, but for more from Pasadena, let's rejoin Keith Jackson. Keith.
A bit of a gray day in Southern California and quite cool, but it's dry. And that's what's important. And the turf has held up well, and we've got ourselves a pretty good football game, half to be played. And right now it's time to enjoy the University of Wisconsin marching band, directed by Michael LaCrone.
Thank you.
Thomas kid's name in Michigan is Anthony?
Yes.
Anthony Thomas.
Our halftime score, 9-3. Stanford leads Wisconsin in the Rose Bowl, presented by AT&T.
The National Car Rental Halftime Report, brought to you by National Car Rental, the official car rental company of the Bowl Championship Series.
ABC wishes you a happy new year.
There is nothing wrong with your television set. We are controlling transmission.
And the best, is yet to come.
Who wants to be a billionaire?
Welcome to television's new millennium.
People call it smart, thrilling, the place for values. Toyotathon 2000. The blockbuster event filled with great Toyota values. Your ride to the new millennium is here. Are you ready to go? Right now, lease Corolla, the best-selling car in history. Just $199 a month and zero down. Zero down. Toyotathon 2000. Corolla's zero down. Now showing exclusively at your Toyota dealer.
Between the sand and the sun, there's a whole lot to do in Florida. So make the most of it, starting now by heading to the Jeep Sunsational Year-End Event, where you'll find great deals like an amazingly low $299 a month lease on a two-wheel drive Grand Cherokee Laredo, with all the power and luxury to take you to the next millennium and beyond. So hurry to the Sunsational Year-End Event, because the sun and the sand will stick around, but these sensational deals won't.
Pay off your holiday shopping with Hero.com and win.
Saturday, New Year's Day, the dawn of a new millennium. Enjoy yourself. Go to the beach. Visit with family and friends. Try a formation skydive or competitive bobsled. Get involved with the running of the Bulls or full contact rugby. Do just about anything, but don't buy a car or truck. Because Sunday is Super Sunday at our 13 AutoWay AutoNation USA dealerships. A one-day sale so big, we're closed on Saturday to prepare. See you Sunday.
Tired of surfing over slow servers? Check out TampaBayLive.com for breaking news, weather, live video, and more. Slide into TampaBayLive.com. It's fast, it's loaded, and it's brought to you by the web wizards of ABC 28. Get out of the slow lane and see the world at your own pace. Log on to TampaBayLive.com, only on the web and only from 28 Tampa Bay News. Here's a live look at current conditions from your 24-hour forecast station.
This is the Bowl Championship Series on ABC Sports as coverage of the Rose Bowl presented by AT&T continues.
We've got a 9-3 ball game, Stanford leading Wisconsin, Dan, and I would suggest to you that 48-day and 38-day layoff hurt both teams' offenses.
And I think it hurt Wisconsin a whole lot more because they've had six possessions in the first half, five punts, and only one field goal. 3 points for Wisconsin in the first half, and Ron Dayne has been totally kept in check.
Well, we're ready to go with the second half of play as they prepare to kick off to Wisconsin, so the Badgers will have the ball as we come out. Vaselli kicking to Nick Davis and Michael Bennett. And the ball's in the air. And it'll go 3 yards deep in the end zone. Davis will put it down. First down, Wisconsin. At the 20, a look at some of the highlights from the first half.
Well, let's take a look at Ron Dayne's one big run. This is a 20-yarder, and this led to a Wisconsin field goal. They're only 3 points up the first half. Stanford got good field position on a catch by Troy Walters down the 1 yard line. Then Kerry Carter powers it in. And this may be the most important play of the first half. A bad snap by Anthony Gabriel, and Stanford does not convert the touchdown.
That's why it's 9-3, a touchdown by Wisconsin. They can take the lead. So missed extra points can be a load. Here comes the second half now with Ron Dayne. That's a 5-yard pickup on his first carry from the 20 to the 25.
Take a look at our Nokia game summary. You can see that Todd Husak has been the most of the offense provider for the Cardinal. Troy Walters, each of those three receptions, all for first downs, and you can see that the lowest first half point total this season.
The offensive front for Wisconsin, McIntosh, Ferrario, Robach, Costa, Tauscher, and Retzlaff, the tight end. Bollinger gives the ball to Dayne up the middle. He goes. He's loose. You do not want him in your secondary. They finally track him down and bring him down. Just short of the 10-yard line, Frank Primus ran him down. But it's first down, Wisconsin, at the Stanford 11-yard line.
Stanford shifts their defense to the strong side, and Wisconsin at halftime made the adjustment that when Stanford shifts strong, we're going to come back weak side. Here goes Kuhn back to the weak side. He's going to lead up inside, but this is Ron Dayne at his very best, making tacklers miss, finding his blocking, and then almost outrunning the secondary for the touchdown. But as it is, a huge play for Wisconsin.
64 yards and first down, Badgers at the Stanford 11-yard line. Kuhn's the fullback, gets a carry. 5-4. He picked up 6-7 yards on that carry. Well, Chad didn't get that many. When you get it tucked in there, boy, he's excited.
And he's a dangerous pass receiver out of the backfield. 11 catches and 2 touchdown receptions. But you know what, Keith? He averages 6 yards per carry.
Yeah, he does.
As well as Ron Dayne. I would have loved to have been in that locker room at halftime to hear Barry Alvarez.
They'll have to repaint it tomorrow. Second down, 3 from the 4. 25 second clock ticking along, and Dayne going to the outside to the corner. Touchdown, Badgers. Demetrius Brown threw a huge block to get him on the corner. So Wisconsin comes out steaming with a big guy, breaking a 64 yard run and then scores.
And Wisconsin football on the ground. There's the block by Kuhns on Tim Smith, and high stepping into the end zone is Ron Dayne. Boy, that was easy for Wisconsin. 4 plays and they're in the end zone, something they couldn't do in the first half.
Wozetski for the point. Good. And Wisconsin goes to the lead for the first time today, 10-9. And we're just started the second half of play.
Okay, really simple. AT&T, 7 cents a minute, all day, every day. That's it. The rest of this commercial is yours to enjoy as you choose. Make calls.
All day, every day. Call 1-800-41-RATE to enroll.
You can express your opinion about the environment on your car, or you can do it with your car. Introducing America's first gasoline-electric hybrid, the Insight from Honda. The most fuel-efficient car in the world.
You're nothing.
Shannon Sharp, please, has always talking trash.
You're paying, baby!
He's always trying to get inside your head.
Lehorn, you don't know your elbows from your...
And sometimes, he can get downright nasty.
I bet you pay transaction fees on your mutual funds. Your mama pays full commission. You know how to calculate a P.E. ratio.
When we created a smarter kind of investment firm...
How diversified is your portfolio?
We created a smarter kind of investor.
You can't even spell Dow Jones. Woo! Okay, guys, let's get this right. To calculate a P.E. ratio, you divide the stock price.
January 9th, the phenomenon is back.
He's won $1 million!
Who Wants to Be a Millionaire returns Sunday, January 9th on ABC.
Now perhaps you have a greater appreciation of why this man holds the all-time rushing record in college football. The Badgers to the lead 10-9, and we'll kick it off here. Pozetsky hits it, gets some air under it, and it goes to Ryan Wells up around the 8-yard line. Going to run a little reverse here. They got a block. It's Davis, and Dave Davis will get it up across the 25 just barely. And first down, Stanford.
Ron Dane carried three of the four plays in this last drive. This is a 64-yarder, his second longest of the year. But he really set the tempo. This is what being a leader is all about, coming out and making the plays. And this is Wisconsin football behind that big left side, McIntosh and Kuhns, and in the end zone on a 4-yarder.
He now holds the career scoring record in the Rose Bowl, 30 points. Breaks the old mark of 25 held by Neil Snow of Michigan, going back to 1902. Here's a little delay. Give it to Brian Allen. That's a mistake. The Badgers are hot right now. Eric Mullick, fighting through the traffic, drops him for a loss.
Well, Stanford tried to counter that great drive with a trick play on the kickoff return. That didn't get him as much as they thought they would get. And now on their first down play, just feeding right into the Badger defense with that very slow developing misdirection.
Davis and Fitz come to the lower side of the picture. They've got four wideouts out there right now on second down and 15. Cusack's pass to the sideline is good. And almost getting away is Tafiti Uso, who had just come into the ball game, and he's hurt.
He really was tackled and fell down awkwardly. And it looks like it might be a left knee or a left ankle. But he came very, very close to breaking it all the way. And that's the one thing about these Stanford receivers. This is Uso, but we've seen Walters and Pitts and Davis. Cusack finds him in the dead zone right there between the safety and the corner. And there is the injury as Fletcher just barely hangs on.
I tell you what, he outruns Doering. If he doesn't get tangled up with Fletcher, he probably scores.
No question.
Well, too bad. Stanford's had the injured bug. But it's a first down up at the 49-yard line. This pass is thrown beyond the reach of Durrani Pitts to the near sideline.
And that was really the first bad pass for Todd Cusack as we look at the Tostitos player comparison for the quarterback. The interesting thing for Brooks Bollinger, all three of these completions to one man, Chris Chambers.
You know what Ron Dane does not have? He does not have touchdown receiving.
He only had one catch all year long. 31 in his four-year career.
In his career, he's never scored a touchdown catching the ball.
He probably won't.
Brian Allen's having a hard time. He just can't get on track. The Stanford ground game is just simply hasn't done anything. Bobby Myers, who was one of those guys that stepped up this year to fill that strong safety spot, he got tangled up with Allen, and he would not turn him loose.
That was a bulldogging tackle there, Keith, wasn't it? I mean, all he didn't have, and now another injury for Stanford as Allen limps off the field. The only thing that Bobby Myers didn't have there was a little rope to tie the three legs together.
Give that cowboy a hand. Third down and 12. Coy Wire is in the backfield. And you've got your four wideouts in there, three wideouts in there. Now, Todd Husak looking at the Wisconsin defense and listening to that other color, big red down there, making all the noise, calls time to talk.
I talked to his secretary. He can't make it.
What do you mean he can't make it?
I mean he can't make it.
Well, if he can't make it, then we got to reschedule the meeting. I mean, this whole project was his idea. If he sees the numbers from research, he's not going to be happy.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, I get physically sick looking at these numbers. Tom, could you hold on a second?
Looking for a good time?
Okay, Tom, about the meeting.
The Civic from Honda.
Sooner or later, you're going to quit smoking. So consider this. A quit date this good won't come along for another 1,000 years. Don't waste it. Quit with Nicoderm CQ. CQ's got the 3 gradual steps, and hundreds of thousands of smokers have already quit with it. Wasn't one millennium smoking enough? Start the next one with Nicoderm CQ. The power to calm, the power to comfort, the power to help you quit.
There's no better time than now to get the good life at Sears. So don't miss out on the best time to buy. Get 0% financing on all Kenmore appliances over $399 till May 2000 when you use your Sears card. Like this Kenmore washer and dryer. You save $120 on the pair, and you get free delivery. Sears, the good life at a great price. Guaranteed. Sears is the proud sponsor of the BCS and the Sears National Champion Football Trophy.
The Rose Bowl presented by AT&T. This ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by Charles Schwab. When we created a smarter kind of investment firm, we also created a smarter kind of investor. Honda, a winning lineup of cars, sport utility vehicles, and minivans. Inspired technology with a human touch. Nokia, connecting people. And Burger King, have it your way.
It is third down and close to 13 for Stanford. They're just trying to weather the storm because Wisconsin has come out of the locker room for the second half red hot. They've got 8 people in the box. Husak back, pass time, passes away, overthrows Derani Pitts. He had him. Pitts was a good 4 yards clear of the nearest defender, and Husak missed him. In the face of the pressure.
Yeah, exactly right, Keith. Watch the pressure right up the middle here. They're trying to get in Husak's face. When you do this to a quarterback, he doesn't step up into his pass. What he does is he throws off balance, and that's the result, a high pass, and that would have been a touchdown for Stanford.
Anthony Gabriel's snap this time is all right. Tolfenrud's kick, pretty good. Fair catch called by Davis, and the Wisconsin Badgers will go to work. Around the 13-yard line, we join Todd Harris.
Thank you, Keith. It's amazing how fortunes change after a 64-yard run by Ron Danis. Coach Willingham was walking off the field. He said he was very happy with his team's performance. In particular, Coach Kemp Bear's defensive scheme. He said, we've won one half. We've got to win another. Coach Alvarez, believe me, he laid into his team. He said, no more sloppy play. I said, what's the problem? He said, we have no rhythm whatsoever. But again, Ron Danis can change that rather quickly. Back to you.
Already has. 13-yard line, first down. Dane. Number 77, Willie Howard, has a hold of him. He picked up 2 yards. You cannot let 255 pounds of elusive fury get loose in your secondary because he'll just run over him.
every time that Stanford's been able to stop him, they've been able to get penetration, and that's what Willie Howard does so well. 19 times this year, he's made tackles in his enemy in the enemy backfield. You got to do it against Dane.
Mullinger to throw it. Sideline pattern is good. And it'll be a first down for Wisconsin. So now they get some daylight behind them.
And Stanford's got to realize, Keith, that Bollinger's completed four passes today, and all four have been a number 88, Chris Chambers. So why don't you put two men on number 88?
I would certainly be tempted. But Davis is, he's dangerous too. See what happens though when Dane can get a shoulder into you. He can ride you for 3, 4, 5 yards. There isn't much you can do about it.
And it appeared that time that when the handoff between Bollinger and Dane happened, they might have got their feet tangled up just a little bit, because Dane was stumbling as he reached the line of scrimmage and still managed to pick up 2.5, 3 yards. But Stanford has got to have an answer for their rushing game, or they're going to be blown out of this second half.
Second down, call it 8. Carlos Daniels in the lineup. He's the single back. Bollinger back to throw it, goes to the sideline. That is too high. Intended for Davis. You said that Bollinger and Dane got tangled up. Well, let Bollinger tell you the story of what happens when Dane ran into him in the Northwestern game.
It wasn't a matter of anyone going the wrong way, but I think, you know, he saw the hole a little tight, and I was trying to get out of the way of the fullback, whatever, and he was already kind of breaking at the hole, and we ran smack into each other, and you know, luckily he still got the handoff, but I had to shake my head a couple times and get my sense back after that one.
Oh, can you imagine?
Yes, I can.
10-9, Wisconsin leading. Third down and 8. Bollinger back. Chased out. Sacked. The first contact, Sharkus Steen. And it put him on his back, Rial Johnson. Wisconsin will punt.
And officially, that's the first sack of the day for Stanford. They came into the game with 46 sacks on the year, but that's a huge one on third down to be able to come up with a play like this. Initially, the protection is pretty good, but you see the safety blitz there by number 13, Tank Williams. There's the shark, Sharkus Steen, getting help from Rial Johnson.
Stepke's punt is away. Good one. High hanger. Ronnie Pitts has to make a fair catch call on it. And he does it at the 32-yard line, where the Cardinal will have it. First down. Wisconsin leads 10-9.
Good morning, Mr. Schwab.
Good morning.
Introducing Velocity from Schwab, the new incredibly powerful online trading software system. With the power to place multiple orders at one time, it's fast and smart. And, if you'll pardon the expression, cool.
I need love, love, to ease my mind.
There's a whole new way to snack and kick back. Introducing single-serving Tostitos snack kits. Just be sure you pick the right time to eat them. Dig in, kick back, Tostitos.
Arizona Angels coming to bat in the first.
Hey, hey, hey! Do you know what time it is? Please. People are trying to sleep down there.
Please.
Let nothing stand in your way. The four-wheel drive Passport from Honda.
This is the Rose Bowl presented by AT&T.
Charles Schwab will make contributions to the scholarship funds of each of the universities represented in the Bowl Championship Series. Not just the Rose Bowl, but all four of them. So here comes Stanford again now. Bit of a ragged effort the last time. Husak back. Gets it away. And it's good. Dave Davis, who's a good leaper. He went high in the air in front of Mike Echols and reeled it in. And it's first down at the 45-yard line of Wisconsin.
Back on Tuesday when we talked to Todd Husak, he said one of our players, or a couple of them, especially the receivers, are going to have to step up. Well, you just saw an example of what he means by stepping up. You hear that term a lot, but this is what it's all about right here. Ball on the way between two defenders. Big play.
45-yard line. Corey Wire as the deep back gets the ball. Found a little bit of daylight. And then he ran into that tree trunk named Godorzy.
A lot of people run into Godorzy
this year, too, don't they?
Made over 100 tackles this year. And the one guy that Barry Alvarez told me he's going to miss more than anybody besides perhaps Ron Dane. He said, if I could clone one player and fill out an entire defensive unit, it would be a player such as Chris Godorzy.
Gain was about a half a yard on that play. It'll be second down. And nine. Play action. Husak buys time and goes deep, and there's nobody home. Troy Walters is shouting at the official that they were holding me. And he gets no sympathy.
That was just great coverage by number two, and Jamar knows it. Man-to-man coverage on the outside with Troy Walters. This is just beautiful coverage.
He's holding him by the coattail right there.
He got away with it, too. And now he's got maybe more speed than Walters. Husak saw that, threw the ball away. But he held away from the official. The official never saw that right hand on the back of Troy Walters.
So it's third down and almost 10. Gets it in there. Look out. Here it goes. Down the middle of the field. It's to the 5-yard line. They'll give him the sixth. Derwani Pitts brought down by Jason Doering.
Keith, the last time Stanford had the ball, Wisconsin came on the blitz, forced the overthrow. So Bill Diedrich, offensive coordinator's adjustment, is to throw the jailbreak screen against that blitz. Great block by Troy Walters will spring this. Number five is Walters. He gets Fletcher out of the way and now quashes down the field, and now Pitts is going to take it all the way to the 6-yard line. Great adjustment by Stanford on offense.
First and goal at the 6. Husak stands up and throws into the end zone, and it is incomplete. Trying to put air under it for Davis. Davis was defended by Echols.
And Echols had his hands all over Davis.
Yep, he did.
But the ball was thrown so far out of the back of the end zone, no way it could be complete. There's a grab right there. Stanford fans see that on the big replay board. And that's what you're hearing.
Second down and goal. Wire goes out and Kerry Carter comes into the backfield for the Cardinal. Tyrone Willingham from Jacksonville, North Carolina. Ball is handed off to the big back, and the Stanford ground game has just not worked at all today. Donnell Thompson, who used to sell soft drinks at Camp Randall Stadium, made the tackle. Donnell twisted an ankle earlier in practice, but he's another one who's made a quick recovery.
Something about playing on New Year's Day and playing in the Rose Bowl will do that to you. Get you healthy in a hurry.
Coy Wire comes back. Now Davis leaves the game. Troy Walters and Derwani Pitts will go to the top of the picture. And it's third and goal. Husak rolls out. Throws. Incomplete. And so the Wisconsin defense turns him away. Jamar Flesher denied Walters any opportunity to catch the ball. And here comes Buscelli in now to put Stanford back into the lead.
You know, in the first half, Fletcher was beaten a couple of times by Walters, but second half, it's been all Jamar Fletcher as he just looks right into the receiver's eyes and anticipates the move.
Guess what? John Sandy has healed himself. He's back in to snap. The regular snapper. Husak, the quarterback, holds it. Oh, bad snap. Got off to the side. It's blocked. So Stanford squanders a glorious opportunity. Having it first and goal at the Wisconsin 6-yard line, the Badgers rise up and turn them away. And the score remains Wisconsin 10, Stanford 9, 5:24 to play in the third quarter.
It seems that the first rule of business today is to be an e-business. The second rule is to work with a company who pioneered the direct way of using the internet as a business tool. Dell built their business around this direct model, which made them a forerunner in e-business. They provided the equipment we needed to use the internet to establish one-to-one relationships with our customers. With Dell's help, we're breaking down the walls between our ideas and reality.
Be direct. Dell. Dell workstations use Intel Pentium 3 processors.
Your website's going to be set up like an MMDS gigabyte with a rotating geostationary satellite. We feel that both you and your customer will appreciate
binary riddles that users love.
You know, that's part of the fun. Wait till you guys see this.
The technology will be obsolete by the time we leave here today, but that's okay because we'll come back.
Who designs your website is up to you. Hooking it up and delivering the goods, leave that up to us.
Of course, you ship everything FedEx.
FedEx. Be absolutely sure.
I love these bowl games. The only thing I don't like is those idiots that paint their faces in all those stupid colors. Don't they have any self-respect? What?
Ten to nine ball game, Wisconsin leading. You want to join ABC Sports in Atlanta for the Super Bowl? Well, watch Monday Night Football for all the details this Monday night. But remember this, you got to watch to win. The ball will be possessed by Wisconsin at their own 9-yard line after blocking the Stanford field goal try. And here come the Cardinals. Stanford shows blitz. And you got an offensive lineman moving on the right side of the line for Wisconsin, I do believe.
And characteristic for Wisconsin to have this many penalties.
Prior to the snap, false start, offense. Penalty is half the distance to the goal. Still first down.
It's their sixth penalty of the afternoon. They come into the game averaging about five. But here's another bad snap for Stanford. Bad snaps on placement kicks today have cost Stanford 4 points and obviously the lead.
The man who blocked that field goal try was Mike Echols, cornerback. They go inside the five, turn around, and give it to that 18-wheeler, and he gets it back out to the nine. Ron Dane, listed at 252. I saw him eating that cake yesterday.
He had a long time off. He hit that rubber chicken circuit, too, didn't he?
Yeah, I got the biggest kick out of him. He said, was kind of complaining. He said he couldn't wait to get away, and in New York City was nice and all that, but he couldn't wait to get back to practice. He said, you know, you get tired. You got to walk around. You got to smile all the time.
It'd be nice to be
getting cramped in the cheeks. Look out. Look out. Oh, boy, he almost popped out of there. He got it out to the 15-yard line. So it's going to be third down and about four before Tank Williams could wrap his legs. Well, you've got Sean Alexander in the Crimson Tide, and you've got Anthony Thomas in the Michigan Wolverines. It's two teams that love to run the football. They love to play great defense. They're in the FedEx Orange Bowl tonight, 8:30 Eastern, 5:30 Pacific. Part of Super January on ABC. Home of the Bowl Championship Series. I don't know if I'm out shouting all that music or not.
Third down and four.
And play clock. They have to call a timeout. They have to call the time. So they do it at 3:57 to play in the third quarter, still leading by a point.
I want it to be a new way of looking at things.
I want it to be larger than life.
I want it to be a customer magnet.
I want it to be the second industrial revolution.
It should transport me wherever I want to go and take me back to where I came from.
I want it to level the playing field.
Nortel Networks is building the new high-performance internet to be whatever you want it to be. So tell us, what do you want the internet to be?
A cash cow.
Come together right now over me.
Hey there, time for a holiday. So switch off your computers and take a national holiday with National Car Rental. Spend some time with national heroes. Or visit a national treasure.
We come back to the Rose Bowl. Wisconsin third down and four. Quick pop to the sideline to Chris Chambers. And Chambers walking down the sideline, hits the chalk just short of the 30-yard line. He almost got away with it. And you got a penalty flag on the field. It's back here on the 15-yard line. Thrown near, very near the sidelines. Hard to see it.
Oh, Kelly did.
Malibu Kelly?
Yep.
Came down from the mountain.
There were two penalties on the play. Offsides on the defense. Illegal shift on the offense. Penalties offset. Repeat third down.
So they come back. Third down and four. Pass play is wiped out.
And Wisconsin has done absolutely nothing on third down as far as converting this afternoon. Just 1 of 8. And coming into this season, one of the best teams in the entire nation. Third in the Big Ten, but 47% is outstanding converting on third down.
Brooks Bollinger, coach's son, North Dakota, asked what was the call, explained it to him, nodded his head, and goes back to work. Same play, same result. Chris Chambers. How many is that? He's completed 6 5 passes to Chambers. Wow.
And this is a third down and short yardage when you think you might want to put a double team on one of the receivers and maybe the only guy that he's throwing the ball to. Chambers beats Chris Johnson there, the nickelback, for an easy third down conversion.
And it's first down Badger just beyond the 30. Dane. Fullback Humes gets a little bit of a wedge for him, and Steen brings down Dane. Ron picks up about 3 yards. Aerial coverage for today's show brought to you by AT&T, proud presenting sponsor of the 2000 Rose Bowl game. That's the vision from up there. We haven't really seen a lot of sun today. We had rain mostly yesterday. And last night, had a helicopter in here today trying to blow the grass dry. It's a new turf, and it's held up very well. Bollinger option, pitch it back behind Dane. He was able to control it. That may be the first time or second time all year that he's pitched it back. Most of the time, he keeps it.
Stanford got murdered by the option against Washington when Marcus Tuiasosopo rushed for 207 yards, passed for 302 for a 500-yard day. But he ran the ball most of it. Bollinger usually runs it for Wisconsin on the option, but Stanford played it perfectly and forced the young quarterback into a bad pitch.
And now it's third down. I know it says six, but I'll guarantee you it's seven if it's an inch. Bollinger looked like he wanted to take off on the quarterback draw. Now he's trying to outrun everybody, and he can't do it. There's a penalty flag on the field as they bring him down right about the line of scrimmage. Mark Stockbauer tracked him down, number 90.
Stanford's defensive game plan has been almost perfect this afternoon. They have contained Bollinger. Haven't quite contained Ron Dayne, but who does? Kent Bear, the defensive coordinator there with the glasses.
They got Chris McIntosh for holding on that call. Sorry, Chris. I'll tell you what, both these teams, so.
Holding on the offense. The penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Show off some young people that are just really striking. They really are.
They're well coached. Both teams are well coached, but the kids help out a lot. I mean, they're intelligent. They do what they're told. They're well spoken, and a real pleasure to be around.
Refusing the penalty brings up fourth down. Stempke hits a high rainbow, and look at Geronte Fitch. He did not call the fair catch. He felt he might be able to split the people covering, and as a result, I think Bose penetrated that two-yard contain area and didn't give him the fair chance. And there he is.
And if you're going to get in that two-yard zone, you might as well get your money's worth and take a good shot. He just went down around the ankle there. Let's take a look at our AT&T action highlight. When's the last time a center snap was anybody's highlight? But we've got two of them for you. This one from Anthony Gabriel. That cost him a conversion after a touchdown. This one by John Sandy. That cost him a three-point field goal as Mike Eccles gets the block. The AT&T action highlight, two snaps for the price of one.
With a minute and 36 to go in the third quarter, a 10-9 lead for Wisconsin. Stanford ball their own 30. Husak gives it away. Inside. Nothing. McCoy Wire. Just about the line of scrimmage.
You get the feeling they're trying to set something up.
Yeah,
with
you do, don't
that.
You?
That's three times today now that they have brought Walters on the fake reverse and handed it to the up back who's got stuffed at the line of scrimmage and lost yardage.
Stanford has run the ball 15 times and gained 23 yards. I was wondering, I asked Mark Ameno if they'd gained any.
Yeah.
The answer is 23.
That's not much.
Second down, 11. Husak looking. That's good protection. Puts air under the ball to the sideline. It's intercepted. Bobby Myers, interception. Pass intended for Troy Walters, and Myers just shut him off. Never gave him a chance.
And a discussion as to whether Myers came down inbounds or not is taking place there right in front of Dave Tipton, defensive line coach there on the left in the Stanford Cardinal. And now they're saying no catch.
You know what? I love to see that, though. I mean, that one official was looking up the sideline, and he knew he didn't come down inside, and he held his ground and said no. Of course, it doesn't make Barry happy, but
Barry's right. He's 53 yards away from it.
He's out.
Oh, I don't know, Keith. Let's see what hits first. Is it his knee? Is it his shoulder? It's his shoulder.
Shoulder.
Well, that is a tough call, but a good job by the officials getting together. What a catch.
Terrific play. But his shoulder and top of him came down out of bounds.
Keith, if that was an offensive receiver making that catch, I'd be arguing that it was a good catch.
I tell you right now, Barry doesn't have a sore knee at this moment. Look at him. He's hot. So it'll be third down 11 as the ball comes back. Swing it out to the outside. Pass completed to Coy Wire. Wire's cracked down by the Badger defense in a hurry. Well short of the first down, and Stanford will have to punt. Jamar Fletcher and Jason Doering with the records on that play for the Badgers.
Remember the last time Stanford faced it, third down and long. They hit the jailbreak screen against the blitz of Wisconsin. That time, Kevin Cosgrove, their defensive coordinator, decided to play zone and let that fine tackling secondary led by Fletcher do the job.
Well, let's see if it's Nick Davis time here as Tolman Rue gets a good snap from Gabriel back in there and hits a low line drive. There's room. There's one. Oh, boy, that's good coverage downfield. Tim Smith. Strong safety.
Keith, you know, that is six punts now for Davis to try to return. And we talked about the fact that he averages almost 14 yards per return on the season, but only one time has he been able to bring the ball back, and that's for 3 yards. So Stanford and Tolbenrud have done a great job of taking that weapon away from the Badgers.
Four ticks remaining on the clock in the third quarter. Carlos Daniel, single back. Running to the left. Going down in the arms of Stockbauer. So 10-9, Wisconsin leads after three quarters of play in the 86 Rose Bowl presented by AT&T. And we'll be back after this message and a word from our ABC station.
Amazing things can happen when you push the right buttons. Introducing the 240 horsepower S2000 Roadster from Honda.
Need more room for your tools? Here's a quick fix. Head to Sears now during the best time to buy. This Craftsman Project Center is just $99.99. Save $60. Sears, proud sponsor of the Bowl Championship Series and the Sears National Champion Football Trophy.
Just hit the buzzer, Andy. I brought something for you from Pets.com.
I'm here to play with the tabby cat.
I'm not going to tell you what it is, but it makes you crazy.
One, two, three. Oh, sorry.
Pets.com, because pets can't drive.
Man, I can tell you from experience, it's really exciting to play in a bowl game. Do you know in the past life I used to be Joe Namath?
Norm, Joe Namath is still alive.
Oh, did I say Joe Namath? I meant Terry Bradshaw.
Throughout the 1900s, Ford has made automotive history. And as this century comes to a close, we're doing it again. Announcing the 20th Century Celebration with the century's biggest deals. It's your chance to see huge savings on every car, truck, minivan, or SUV in stock. Like up to $1,500 cash back on a best-selling Ranger. Up to $1,500 cash back on a best-selling Explorer. Or take $1,500 cash back on Windstar. Just get to your Southern Ford dealer now, because when the 20th Century Celebration is over, it's history.
The GMC Convoy 2000 is here. Trucks with capabilities that will change the way you look at the road. Professional-grade pickups, SUVs, and family vans designed better than they need to be. Like the 2000 GMC Sierra Extended Cab with the most powerful standard V8 in its class. Get up to $1,587 average finance savings with 3.9% APR on select 2000 Sierra models. GMC. Do one thing, do it well.
Here's a live look at current conditions from your 24-hour forecast station.
Watching ABC's coverage of the Rose Bowl presented by AT&T.
A 10-9 lead for the Wisconsin Badgers as the sun begins to sink toward the Pacific. And we go to the final quarter of play. That's Dave Kaiser and Al Horsch, who went into the Rose Bowl Hall of Fame yesterday. Al still holds a record, 102 yards and a kick return for a touchdown.
And a future Hall of Famer for the Rose Bowl and perhaps a few other Hall of Fames. Ron Dane.
You've got that right.
Crank it up here in the fourth quarter as he did to Stanford a long time ago.
Freshman, he showed up in the fourth quarter, ran for 75 yards. He looks to be the key man here. Well, Bollinger keeps that one and turns it upfield for a nice gain on second down and 10.
You know, somebody else was inducted into the Rose Bowl Hall of Fame yesterday along with Al Horsch and Dave Kaiser.
The people out in the audience that I would like to...
Al, Dave, and my boss, Congratulations, partner.
Thank you, man.
Well, of course, you went in the NFL Hall of Fame. 1993, right?
Yeah, but I'm Mr. Never Been to the Big One. I never played in the Super Bowl or this great bowl game either.
Yeah, but you were hell on wheels for the Oregon Ducks. I know that.
And winners of the Sun Bowl yesterday over Minnesota. Go Ducks!
Only Pac-10 team so far to win, isn't it?
Yep.
Third down and a little more than five as Bollinger runs out of trouble and will pick up a first down and then some. He's near midfield. First down for the Wisconsin Badgers. So the redshirt freshman starting to make some plays now. Sharkus Steen on the tackle.
You know, Bollinger, they say he's a 4'7", 40 guy, but he's one of those athletes that plays faster than he times maybe on a track here. Good recognition there as Dane gets another nice block, and Sharkus Steen can barely get out there for his 11th tackle of the afternoon.
Well, there's that old argument that there's speed and there's football speed.
Yep, he's got football speed.
Yep. So front midfield, first down, drop back, looks to throw. Can't set his foot, can't find anybody. Now he's going to run around the crowd. Willie Howard's after him, and the penalty flag goes down. Another one on the sideline. So you got two flags, Stockbauer, and come flying through there, and probably hit him a little late.
And but before that, Keith, I think they're going to get Wisconsin for holding. First flag thrown by our referee, Dennis Hennigan.
I think these people have done a pretty good job, don't you?
Yeah, and a real good example there, as you saw Bruce Palmer, the umpire, come over and talk and settle down the Wisconsin sideline there.
Two penalties during the play, holding on the offense. After the play was over, personal foul on the defense.
Tyrone Willingham is so stoic, he just Barry on the other side is thundering away. Here's the hold.
And it's your boy Chris McIntosh, number 75, working on Willie Howard. And as Bollinger gets to the outside, we can't quite see the hold there, but Howard with great effort. There's the cheap shot by Stockbauer. It's a cheap shot because he knew that Bollinger was heading sideways going out of bounds. No need to hit the quarterback and no need to hit him that late.
Oh, that's a quarterback talking, folks.
Who's been hit one too many times.
I can't hear the referee.
The personal foul will be assessed because it happened after the play. So they go from the line of scrimmage and mark it off, and the Wisconsin fans love it.
They feel they got something out of it anyway, huh?
If what not a bruise for their young quarterback.
That's right. It's down to the 46-yard line. Time remaining in the football game, 13:55, and right now I'm beginning to get the feeling that Wisconsin is beginning to win along the line of scrimmage.
And they're winning the game, the battle for field position, too. Right now they're in Stanford territory, and you look at the Cardinal on defense, a lot of them standing there with their hands on their hips. And that's a sure sign of fatigue.
That was a 10-yard penalty on Wisconsin, a 15-yard penalty on Stanford, so it's first 10. And handed off to the big man, and Dane runs into a huge pile. The national championship, the Seminoles of Florida State and the Virginia Tech will be added in the Sugar Bowl down in New Orleans on January 4. Number one Florida State, number two Virginia Tech, the Nokia Sugar Bowl, and the Sears Trophy to be presented to the winner of the Nokia Sugar Bowl in this year's national championship game. On second down and eight, Bollinger thrown down for a huge loss by Rial J.
Johnson. The loss is all the way back to the 42-yard line.
Kent Bear's got to love that. First sack of the afternoon for Rial Johnson. Had 19 on the season. This one is absolutely huge because now Wisconsin will face a third down and a mile for the first. And the battle of field position now goes in Stanford's favor.
Well, they're calling it third down and 22. They run the big bag. He bounces outside and gets some of it back. He moves the football back to the 50-yard line where it was a little while ago. And it'll be fourth down for Wisconsin. This guy, number 10 right there, Tim Smith, has gotten very much involved in things around the line of scrimmage of late.
And he had to battle the flu earlier in the week. But ex-quarterback showing his toughness now as a strong safety and a big playmaker. Six interceptions this season.
Stemke in the punt. That's Durrani Pitts waiting for it. It's a high hanger. And a fair catch called by Pitts just short of the 20-yard line. So it'll be Stanford ball, first down at its own 19. Time remaining in the game, 11:43. Wisconsin by one.
Hey there, time for a holiday. So switch off your computers and take a national holiday with National Car Rental. Spend some time with national heroes. Or visit a national treasure. Join the National Football League. Or take your kids to a national park. But wherever you go, National will get you there fast. Because with hundreds of locations nationwide, it's hard to find a place that's not a national city. Woohoo! National Car Rental. What are you waiting for? Let's go!
AT&T. 7 cents a minute, all day, every day.
Take one of these. That'll be 25 cents.
But it says here it's a nickel.
Not for a couple of hours.
What?
Well, see, sometimes it's a nickel, but right now, it's a quarter.
It's like that long-distance nickel plan where they say it's a nickel.
Sometimes they charge you 25.
That's right.
That's where we got the idea.
Is that right?
7 cents a minute, all day, every day, even to Canada with our international plan.
You know, there are some stores that sell candy for one low price all day long.
And people like it?
Oh, they love it.
Call 1-800-41-RATE to enroll.
In any business, there can be only one priority. At Morgan Stanley Dean Witter, we have never forgotten ours. Not surprisingly, we measure success a little differently.
Now that's a plan.
You gave me the idea?
Well, maybe I vaguely inspired something.
We used to charge different prices at different times.
Like that long-distance nickel plan.
Sometimes it's a nickel, sometimes it's a quarter.
But you changed because you wanted to be more like
AT&T. 7 cents a minute, all day, every day.
Oh, you're the man.
Yeah, you the candy man.
You're the 7 cents man.
Well, every child has a dream.
7 cents a minute, all day, every day, even to Canada with our international plan. Call 1-800-41-RATE to enroll.
This January, the main event is on ABC.
I'm the greatest. I am king of the world.
Muhammad Ali, king of the world. ABC Monday, January 10th.
Lights are on. Darkness is settling down. On the 86th playing with the Rose Bowl presented by AT&T, and we've still got ourselves a cracking good football game. Stanford owns it first down at his own 19-yard line. Wisconsin leading 10-9. Offensives have not been able to get on Frank much. Haynes had one big run of 64 yards, and Husak is hit as he throws. The ball is short and complete. Here's Todd Harris with a special guest.
Special indeed, Keith. Thank you very much. He's a Stanford alum, a Heisman Trophy winner, and he won here at the Rose Bowl. Jim, I got to ask you, it's been a long time since Stanford won this, but this would be a good time to do it.
Well, it certainly is, and they're playing extremely well. I don't think anybody expected it to be as close as it is, and Stanford has every opportunity to win this ball game right now.
This has got to be a position where quarterbacks love to come in. What do you think Todd Husak's thinking right about now?
Oh, get the ball to his wide receivers, let them make the big plays.
What do you think about Stanford's chances as they drive down with Troy Walters in the game?
I think it's great that he's been able to play and contribute and not just be out there for the heck of it. So, you know, it gives Stanford another dimension with Troy in there.
Best of luck to you. Thanks for your time.
Thank you. All right, gotcha.
Jim Plunkett, good guy. Yeah, boy, I saw him way too many times from the opposite sideline, starting in 1970 when he came up to Eugene and beat our Ducks and went on to do all those great things in his career, including a couple of Super Bowl wins with those Raiders.
Well, you could tell when he first showed up, though, he was going to be something special. He had great poise and work ethic.
Yeah, he was a man playing among boys.
Third down now and 10 for Stanford. Wisconsin backs out. The linebackers drop. Pressure, down he goes. Terrific play by Ben Herbert. Number 42 came flying through and made the tackle.
He's only made to one other sack all year long, but here he is, 42, working against Greg Schindler there, overpowers Schindler, and easily takes down the quarterback.
This time the punt has to come out of the end zone. Tolpenruh, the snap, gets it out. Wisconsin's going to get a real good field position here. It's going to be right about the 40-yard line on the Stanford side of the field. Advantage hugely here for Wisconsin. I'm out.
Beginning to think of the automobile not just as a family vehicle, but as a personal and individual means of transportation.
The throb of a powerful engine. Now for a moment, imagine yourself as driver of this automobile.
You really have to drive it.
At the Chrysler Proving Ground.
Give them an expressway and their drivers are
well. I think we've made the scenic back roads fun to drive.
Or give them any country or suburban road, rough or smooth.
They're the type of people who like the feel of a fine machine.
Love to drive. The renowned engineers of Chrysler.
A minimum of ornamentation and a minimum of chrome moldings.
Need a regular firecracker.
The sounds of nature sing their prettiest over the rich, throaty obbligato of his engine.
Even sheet metal can have a soul.
And they give you back the romance of driving.
And that is why these will never land on an ordinary car.
And you find out what exceptional unity of man and machine has been achieved.
We've had success with that.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Our company's made huge strides in e-commerce.
No. Who hasn't?
We've got web-based order tracking. We can analyze our customer data in all kinds of ways. I mean, it's amazing.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's the same with us.
Yeah. So how did you guys integrate your ERP?
Burp? Confused about e-business? Don't be. Get the software, services, and partners that make it easier. The business internet starts with Microsoft.
The Rose Bowl, presented by AT&T. This ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by AT&T One Rate 7 Cent Plan. One simple rate all day, every day. Chrysler, giving you back the romance of driving. Morgan Stanley Dean Witter, we measure success one investor at a time. And Sears, and the Sears National Champion Football Trophy.
Wisconsin will enjoy great field position, and this is the story of the game so far. Morgan Stanley, Dean Witter, game stats. Stanford doing nothing on the ground. Wisconsin playing Wisconsin football.
Ron Dane. He's going to have 6 yards on that carry and put it at the 34-yard line. This is the best starting point of a possession for Wisconsin in the ball game.